Theo, are you done with your chips, sir?
Almost.
Doritos.
Spicy at that.
Spicy, because this about to get spicy.
Tell me something, man.
Not because you're a fucking dream world.
Are you happy in this modern world?
I'ma wrap up this shit one day. That's what she said.
Welcome to Love and Then What?
Welcome, lovers and friends. I'm your boy, Miss Everybody, joined today with my co-host,
Theo Dolce.
And we are joined today by musician and rapper K Dusse from Orlando, Florida. Currently residing in New Jersey. How you doing, sir?
I'm all right. Thanks for having me on, man.
Oh, thank you for coming. Now, what? All right, so everyone that's listening right now just heard me say you lived in Orlando, Florida.
Yeah. Why the fuck would you come down here?
Why would you come? You know how I'm so sick of being cold, bro.
Okay. As long as it's a personal.
Nah. Okay. I tell you, you know what I mean? Like, I was on with my first son's mother. You know, things didn't work out. So long story short, I didn't know that she called my relatives down here in Jersey because, you know, I was going from house to house because me and her broke up. So I guess she went and told them I was homeless or whatnot. And then next thing you know, they came down. It was like, no, you're bringing your ass up to Jersey. You know what I mean?
So did you move to Florida for this woman and then you guys broke up?
My mom moved from Plainfield to Florida. I had to be like at least 10 years old.
Okay.
So, you know what I mean? I stayed in Florida, raised in Florida, finished my elementary, middle school, high school.
Mm-hmm. Damn, I lived in Florida. I lived in like the Panhandle for like 6 months.
And I lived in Orlando. It was beautiful.
I lived in Florida for like a weekend when I was out there for my game. No, but that's dope though, because that means that you got like family that actually cares about you. Came down and get you. Come on, you coming back with us.
Yeah.
That's fucking dope.
Yeah, it is.
Because people don't got family like that.
It was my grandmother, my aunt, and my cousin. They was not taking no for an answer. So
they love you, bro.
All right, yeah.
They love you. They love you because that's big right there.
Now, we're both big guys. When I go to a new city, first thing I'm looking for is food. Who has the better food, Jersey or Florida?
Florida.
What do they got that's so good? I can't think of maybe
a Cuban.
Because
there's so much of a selection. Mm-hmm. You know, because it's so many nationalities, so mm-hmm. many different things.
Okay.
Like it's limited the range compared to Jersey. Like I'm living in Pemberton, so
mm-hmm.
the food selection out there is very scarce. Like mm-hmm. even after get a good meal, we had to go out to Cherry Hill or something like that. Or yeah. either to get soul food, I have to go to Oakland mm-hmm. or Camden or something like that.
Yeah. See, I don't know too much about Jersey.
Yeah, what is Pemberton, for people that are listening and don't really know what Pemberton is, what kind of community is it?
Well, you know, the neighborhood I live in is called Lake Valley. It's a nice neighborhood.
It's like suburbs or a rural?
Yeah, suburbs.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, you live in the burbs?
Yeah.
Getting money.
Man, you know, I ain't want my kids to grow up and be raised the way that I grew up, so.
Yeah, because
I lived in a project, so.
Yeah.
I ain't know what the suburbs was.
Now, you talked about that before when you were on the podcast. If for those listening or watching at home, you were on the Beast on the Beat. You and your producer were on there for about 10 minutes. Quick little short one, but you did talk about how it was important for you to raise your kids in the suburbs so they didn't experience things that you did as a kid.
Yeah.
What things happen to you that you don't want to happen to your kids? Like, what things specifically are you talking about?
Man, it's so easy to get in trouble in the hood, but it's very hard to get out of trouble in the hood, too. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. me, you know, my mom was a drug addict, so, mm-hmm. you know, I grew up different. You know what I mean? Like, sometimes I had to fend for myself, me being the oldest brother, and I had to look out for my little brothers.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I had to resort to illegal shit, breaking in shit, selling drugs, you know, whatever, to get the dollar.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I ain't had no father figure, so you know, I made a pledge to myself that no matter what, I'll try the best I can and be the best father mm-hmm. that I can be.
Right. So, do you feel like suburban kids are soft? Like, do you feel like your kids are softer now that they're not growing up in the hood situation?
In certain situations, in certain like situations, certain things. Yeah,
you're like, come on, man. I went through this shit, and you're going through this. And
nah,
like,
yeah, because I say it to him all the time. You know, I'm like, man, y'all soft as hell.
But understanding that us growing up in the hood, you. That's what you had to become.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, even if you're not like altercational, like you might not get into altercations, but growing up in the hood, you still have to learn how to defend yourself, know how to take these certain situations. So I get it when you're saying that your kids growing up this way, they won't have the same like.
Yeah, they don't know what cockroaches is or none of that.
Yeah, so how you growing up, because you said you don't want them to grow up like that, they won't. And they aren't, so you can't expect them to even do the shit you done. Like, he hit you, hit that nigga back. Like, that's not in their mindset. You know what I'm saying? So, half the time.
Like, yeah, it's just, I don't know, man. It's like, because, boy, when I moved to Orlando, everybody think Orlando all Disney World and shit. Yeah, that's that side of Orlando, Kissimmee, borderline, that's that side.
Yeah.
But me, I stayed on the west side of Orlando. Project buildings.
Mm. I can tell. You get whole demeanor change.
I'm going to tell you how real it was. When I first moved from Jersey down there, man, these boys whooped my ass every day. But I didn't run. I got tired. I couldn't run. And even when I did try to run, it was so many of them, I didn't know where I was going. So they do all the shortcuts and shit. So they were, he's going over here. We'll meet him over here. So, and it's crazy because I tried out for the baseball team and I made it.
Mm-hmm.
I was playing center field. So, you know, they used to chase me home, beat my ass every day. And then like, one day I just started fighting with them every day. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, in the hood, you got the grown-ups on the corner. They like, nah, if you got a problem with this man, give him a one-on-one. So they finally gave me the one-on-one, and me and the dude fought.
Tore some nigga up, dude.
Yeah, and then after that, the everybody embraced me. They was like, all right, he ain't no punk. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you was running around chasing him.
Yeah, then when the new people came around, then I with them.
You lead the charge. Let's get
him. Yeah, pretty much.
So how many kids do you have?
Four.
Four? Okay. So we get a beer based off of every guest. I actually got three for you. Okay. This one is plain chicken nuggets. This is based off of how picky kids are. You've raised a kid at every single age. My nieces were over this weekend. Plain chicken nuggets. No ketchup, no mustard, no nothing near. It can't touch the chicken nugget. Mm. And I don't think anything encapsulates what a kid is more than a plain chicken nugget because they're so picky. Are your kids, or growing up, were they picky about anything specifically?
Man, my kids are picky, period.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's the way I raise them because they're spoiled.
Mm-hmm. The privilege.
Yeah. Like, I told them, man, what? When I grew up, whatever was on that damn plate, I had to eat it from my grandma, my aunt. It didn't matter. Yeah.
And if you ain't want it, you had to finish it before you left the table.
It was like certain things they knew I wouldn't eat and they wouldn't make it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like I wouldn't eat potato salad mayonnaise, you know what I mean?
Oh, I don't like mayonnaise either.
So, you know, they knew that.
What?
So
I don't like mayonnaise or olives. Two things.
I thought white people.
I know what it is.
Undercover brother.
Yeah, plain chicken nuggets should be a sponsor, by the way.
I was just watching it.
I was going to say, you know what? I was going to wait until I was on Larry and Lionel's podcast with you. But the way you guys characterize some, not all black people, obviously, but the way you guys characterize white people in that show is basically like what I was thinking of as undercover brother, white guy. Mm-hmm. How there's always that one white guy in every situation, like in every black, like all black cast, there's always that one white guy that they dog on the whole time that is just like, oh, like they're always dirty and shit. I'm like, yo, there's other white dudes out there.
Yeah.
Undercover brother was that weird. I was just really watching that. So speaking of mayonnaise, that was crazy because she gave him a sandwich and it was just.
Oh, but that girl was so fucking hot.
She was hot. She was hot as shit.
Like my 8-year old, he's very picky, but he's autistic too.
Mm-hmm.
So you know what I mean? Like he's weird. It's weird. His eating is weird. Like he only. Candy he like is fruit snacks.
Mm-hmm.
He don't like chocolate. He won't eat cookies. A snack to him is a chicken thigh, or a pork chop, or some macaroni and cheese or something like that. That's a snack to him.
Mm.
And I'm like, you know, now my 12-year-old, he's a junk food fanatic.
Yeah,
but man, he's a picky eater, but he eats good. Like he don't eat no BS.
Yeah, he's good eats, man.
Yeah, he good eats.
Like, They'll tell you I don't eat no condiments.
And like, yeah, he's weird because he put ketchup on everything. I seen him put ketchup on pancakes and eat it.
Ew, man.
Man, listen, man, that's my boy, man.
I hate people that put ketchup on eggs. Like, why are you doing that?
Because it's delicious.
That is disgusting.
I had it this morning. It was amazing.
Why are you putting ketchup on eggs in the morning?
You know, I don't know. Ketchup is a food enhancer. Ketchup is a food enhancer.
I can't put no ketchup on my egg.
I can't put ketchup on shit, but not eggs. That like
even when I have a breakfast sandwich, I can't put ketchup on it. I'm weird. I got to put jelly or jam on it.
I ain't even going to lie to you, man. The poppy dude when I was a little bit younger, made me a sandwich, a breakfast sandwich, and I was so mad. Like, who the fuck puts mayonnaise on a breakfast sandwich?
Yeah.
Because I thought it was cheese until I just kept going.
Yeah, mayonnaise is disgusting.
I'm like,
and it
yo.
Was hot too, wasn't it?
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, yo, bro. I'm like, yeah. I know he didn't put mayonnaise on it.
Now,
I lift a piece of bread up.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, gulp.
Now, I can fuck with like macaroni salad, but it has to be light mayo. If it's used as like a way to like bring food together, I'm cool with that.
I hate people that put mayonnaise when they don't with tuna fish. Like, leave it alone. You got to, I guess.
All right, so if I'm being healthy, I'm going to put mustard on my tuna fish.
Ew, see, that's nasty.
And you know
too.
How I learned that from? The greatest wrestler that ever lived, Stone Cold Steve Austin. But
you look like him.
I know I do. I know I do. Shit.
If he was a cab driver.
That was my
if I was this if hat. Was a, this if he hat was a cab is a, driver. This hat is amazing. Everyone that meets me says that's the best hat I've ever seen. How can I pay you to just wear that hat around me, sir? Everyone says that.
And if it is head so perfect.
He got that shit teller. He got it teller. Give me three quarters right here. On my forehead.
He got that thing suited.
And this is cashmere, so it's fancy. Okay.
Big
fancy.
Money.
For Christmas, my girl bought me like three hats. Because, I mean, when you're a fat guy, bald, with a beard, I mean, hats are basically half your personality.
Yeah.
So,
tell me about it.
So, I mean, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know exactly so. What you're talking about.
Y'all don't take your hats off?
Nah, man, I ain't trying to hat fish nobody.
I won't wear a hat around the house unless
do people know you're bald?
Yeah, people know I'm bald, but you know I ain't got a haircut. Yo, so, you know, my hair grow on the sides, but it ain't growing up top.
No problem.
There's a lot of people that wear hats so much that I don't know, like, what's underneath. Some of them have hair, and most of them are bald.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, nah, yeah, I'm bald.
Now, if I didn't buzz my head in a few days, like, this hat ain't coming off.
You bald?
Yeah.
First time I seen him without his hat on, a hat on this show was last week because he was eating his hot chip, and everything had to come off.
Oh, that one chip.
I had
chip.
That one chip challenge.
Yeah.
You ain't see the episode?
Yeah, I did. Yo, man.
He spit the ice. He ate ice cream and then spit it back. Oh, my God.
He was trying to do anything to cool it.
You know what the worst part about that whole thing is? I'm lactose intolerant. Like, I don't know if it was the chip that fucked me up or eating 1,000 calories of ice cream afterwards.
Nah, I think the chip
you
was.
Your
up.
Ass was on fire when you
bro,
were going
the
to the
next
bathroom,
day,
bro.
I was... I woke up that night like three or four times, and I woke up Ash. I was like, Dave, I can't do this.
What made me stay away from
it? I would pick Cobby on it.
When I seen somebody eat it, and they started sweating, and they only ate a corner of it.
I
was
like,
damn.
And like 10 minutes later, just throw up like bad. Like bad, bad throw up.
My girl ate a corner, and nothing happened to her. She was fine.
Like online, I seen it online. This dude gave one to a crackhead and said, I give you $100, you eat this chip. Crackhead, like, I love spicy shit. Okay. Mug ate that chip. Next thing you know, she was around you running around the yard. I'm like, yo.
Nope.
If that chip make noises like that, I don't want it.
I don't want that shit, man. Let's taste this, man.
No, I told myself.
I think it's pretty solid. Like, it's not like too heavy of a
it don't taste like chicken nuggets.
It ain't no bitter critter. It's bad. It ain't bad.
You got another one or it was just three?
I have three different beers.
I'm saying, was it another one of these?
Yeah.
Nah, that's
like an extra?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I was going to ask him if you wanted one of these?
Chicken nugget beer.
So that's my little bro, Cobby, the graphic designer that I want everybody to tap into, you know, from time to time.
So how did you...
It's not that bad.
Yeah, so you ain't no better critter.
I told you, yeah, it's good.
IPA's got aftertaste, though.
Yeah.
We got two more to come, so there could be some aftertaste coming.
Pause.
So for people that are watching at home, they don't see that. Is it your girlfriend or your wife? Your friend?
It's a long story.
It's not to be spoken about right now.
No, it ain't that. You feel me? Like... like it, you could say my girlfriend slash best friend slash, you know.
Okay, I get it.
How long have you guys known each other?
Years.
Years?
How long you been back here? Well, not here because you don't live up here, but Jersey.
It's been about 14 years.
Well, so you've been Jersey. Back. You've been back in Jersey for 14
yeah,
years?
Yeah, but I still go home, though.
I thought, I ain't even going to lie to you, I thought you, like, kind of just moved back here and shit.
Nah, but I just, but the reason, like, I be letting people know because, man.
You're not.
Because Florida, you know what I mean? That's where I experienced life.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I grew up at. That's where I grew up at. That's where I experienced life. I had my first girl, smoked my first blunt, drank my first drink. You know what I mean? Played football, scored my first touchdown.
Yeah. What position?
Well, I played a lot of positions. I played linebacker, running back. I played on the line.
So when you scored your first touchdown, what position was you playing?
At the time, I was playing center.
Yeah.
And we was on the, like, the 3-yard line. Yeah. We were playing against front line.
Did you fumble?
Lake, man, no. I hiked the ball, and the dude fumbled the handoff. And I just picked it up, and I was out. And that's when the coaches was like, yo, we didn't know you was that fast.
Yo, similar. Yeah. I was playing Little League. So, you know, when you first start Little League football, I don't know if y'all know, when you first start Little League football, they put you in a position that they think they want you to put you. So I started on the offensive line. Then I started on the defensive line. And so I played defensive line. And then our first scrimmage game, we played against this team. They was big as fuck. So the one dude pushed me back to, like, the linebackers and the cornerback. He was just blocking me so crazy. And the quarterback got sacked and threw the ball up. And I was all the way back in, like, the secondary. I caught the ball. I made the first dude miss, and I took it, like, 60 yards. Mm-hmm. Burnt everybody. Coach was like, oh, shit, I didn't know you was that fast. Next practice, I'm at linebacker.
Yeah, I know. And
shit went up from there.
That's how it was with me. After that game, coach said, I got something for you at practice.
Yeah, yo.
Then he put me at fullback, and then he was like, because I always had size, because everybody thought I was going to be this giant-ass kid, because, you know, when I was, like, 12, I was 215. But I was the same height I am now.
Mm.
So, you know, I always had size. So, and then when I started going to high school and I started wrestling, running track, playing football, you know, the muscles started coming.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, but, like, I never played JV, freshman, anything because of my size. So, as soon as I came to high school, straight varsity.
Funny thing is, y'all probably won't believe me when I say that, like, Little League before I went to high school and shit, I was playing fullback.
I can't believe that you were playing O-line in any world.
Well, I was a kid. Man, I was probably like six. When you were six, they put you anywhere.
Yeah, now me coaching my son's team and stuff, now I understood.
Yeah, you pick kids anywhere until they show you.
It's because you don't know, so you know you have first-year players and everything.
Mm-hmm. And me being my first year, like, that was the scrimmage game, and I caught a pick and ran it 60 yards, beat everybody, made a move. But when I got to linebacker, the dude that I was playing linebacker with, he was hitting.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, you embrace the mentality of somebody else sometimes. So him hitting at a young age, we used to go watch wrestling and come back and do wrestling moves on people in games. And me and him was just animals. So they took him and made him a tight end on the other side of the ball, and they made me a fullback. So all I would do, since I like to hit, I'm coming through the middle of the hole. The first person I see, lay him out. Boom. Lay him out.
That's what they knew about me, because I love to hit.
In high school,
man,
I got
like
benched,
one thing, what man? They know I hit. I didn't care. Mm-hmm. I didn't give a fuck how big you was. I was coming, and you know football wasn't soft back then as it is now.
Yeah, no, it was crazy.
So you know, boy, I tell you what, transitioning from Jersey to Florida.
I know.
Football,
it was
different.
I know it's
because you
difference.
Know I was used to being dominant because I always had the size. But then when I went to Florida, that shit changed.
They eat different.
Man, first time I got hit, I had to get smelling salt. Big dude, motherfucker had to run like a 4 or 5. Big dude hit me. Boom. Next thing you know, I remember waking up to them with the shit in my nose.
What's that smell like?
It's crazy.
I never smelled it before.
It's like, it's not, I can't explain it. It's not like, it's not no smell to it, but when
it's like
smell
somebody just
it,
hit
it's
your,
like
immune system.
It hits
like,
your shit and everything.
Open up.
And like, damn, I was
like smelling
ammonia. Better.
Mm-hmm. It's ammonia. Come out.
It's ammonia. That's
ammonia.
What it smells like, ammonia.
It's ammonia. I think that's what it is because, you know why I gave up football though? Because I'm the same size as, like, when I was Little League and I was like getting bigger, I was the same size in high school. So I'm like 5'3".
Mm-hmm.
And coming from literally playing fullback, hitting shit, I came to play quarterback. Then they put me at running back. And a fullback mentality, what we know, yeah. it holds. We're not yeah. going outsides. Mm-hmm. You're not allowed to run outsides. You stay in between the tackles and the guards. You don't never go outside. I had to learn that shit so bad because I'm little. And then I got hit like Sheldon Brown hit Reggie Bush that one time. I got up.
That was, the best hook of all time.
You got up and was like, that's it.
I swear to God. The dude that hit me, remember I told you, the boy that I played Little League was the middle linebacker. He ended up being like 6'4", 6'5", big mm-hmm. as shit.
Yeah.
And we were playing against them. Mm-hmm. And it was a punt. And I'm running off the field. He blindsided me. Took everything. Mm-hmm. I got up laughing like, ha, 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 and died right then and there.
That was it.
Like, I crawled off the field. I ain't even going to lie to you. And then after that, I played one more game, and I was just like, ah.
I used to love doing that to people. Yeah. Them and making them quit. Yeah. I don't know why, yep. man. It just gave me an excitement when
it
I
seems
hit.
Mean. It seems mean.
I know, but, man, you know it's a competitive
Fuck you.
Sport.
Dude,
I hit them wild. They be like, oh, we'll play no more. I be like, yeah, right. I hit your ass so hard, you quit.
Fuck you, man.
One of your kids ever get hit so hard that you got mad? Or did they ever hit somebody so hard that you were proud?
Yeah, both.
Both?
Because my son, his first year of playing, so he didn't know nothing about crackbacks, and I told him about it. And mm-hmm. I told him I practiced with him because I ended up putting my equipment on with him in the backyard, mm-hmm. and I showed him what it was, and I hit him.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know what I mean? And then he go in the game and do the same fucking thing we've been working on with all goddamn summer, and you mm-hmm. first thing you do, you blocking the dude, you know he on you. He mad at you because you dominating him. Mm-hmm. So he crackbacks him.
Mm-hmm.
He gets up, he shakes it off and get up, you know what I mean? Next play, he going to knock the kid on his ass, but it made me mad because I was like, man, you going to crack me? Because everybody was like, ooh. And I was like, damn, it had to be my son.
That crack, yo, crackbacks be crazy,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, everybody was like, oh.
Yeah, talking about the feet being in the air. You like, shit.
And you know, I couldn't complain to be mad because it was fucking clean.
Yeah.
So, but you know, I'm not one of those parents. Oh, you hit my kids, and oh, it's football. This is what This is what they want to do. This is what you signed up for.
That's why moms don't come to games, because they be like, oh, that's my fucking. I'm like, yo, calm the fuck down.
Nah, yeah, I know. I had to explain to this mom. Listen, we're not doing that.
Real shit. They're around
the field. Like, listen. This is a man sport. This is a contact sport. They out here with helmets, shoulder pads, and shit. What you think they're gonna play two hand touch? No.
Mm-hmm. But just like boxing, yeah. football is scary, bro.
Yeah, it's very scary. One wrong hit, one wrong thing you could do, you can end yourself for the rest of your life. You can paralyze anything. It's a risk.
Playoffs just happened last Sunday. Was it the Cardinals?
Yeah.
I don't know. The boy, he tried to make a hit on the running back.
Running back, yeah.
Boom. And he flipped. The running back got like ran him over kind of. And he kind of flipped, and he just was like stuck. And I'm like, yo.
They had to unscrew his helmet.
Yeah.
They had to
take the scrub and all, you know, because his –
I ain't seen nobody get carted off the field of football in a long time.
Yeah, bro.
And you know what I'm saying? And it was like, damn.
That'd be the scary part about it. Like, just like boxing, man. I can't say that if I have a son, I'll let him box. Or, like, if I put him in boxing, I don't know if he's going to be, like, a fighter. Like, just going to fight and have fights. You can learn it. Learn the sport just to protect yourself. But mm-hmm. even with football, I'd rather put him in baseball or basketball. Yeah, you know I mean, just to protect it how it is, even though they protecting you now, but I don't know. I mean, it sounds like a little soft a little bit because you don't want your sons to be soft like that. But just how football is nowadays, man, and how shit is, I don't know, it just feels different nowadays.
Yeah, but football is more watered down. It's more about the safety and stuff mm-hmm. these days now than compared to when we were growing up. Like, you know, Ronnie Lott, Brian Dawkins, like, you know what I mean, Ed Reed. Like, you know, those hard-hitting people. You know what I'm saying? Lynch.
You played Little League, right?
Huh, yeah.
You played Little League, right? After the games, what were we playing? Before you even left the field. If you watching other games playing, what were you on the sideline doing?
We would still be throwing the football around, throwing around, playing everything.
You know what killer man is?
No. What is
when you throw somebody, you throw the ball,
catch it, and they got to, like, run.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
But you are hitting with no equipment. Like, if your coach seeing you,
I know what it's
he'll make you run forever. Or do some shit. But Killer Man was the craziest shit. I'm like, yo, we used to do that on cement.
Yeah.
We used to call it something different, but I can't say it on the show.
What? I know. Smear the.
Yeah,
I got white friends, all right? I grew up with some white friends, all right? So that's what they used to call
it. Call
it what? When you play any man, because in the hood, we call it any man, you know what I mean? But they call it smear the, you know what I'm saying? Can't say it. I ain't trying to get banned to block. You feel me?
Is it a wrong word?
Take your right headphone off. I'll tell you.
Nah, that's what it was called.
Wait, hold, I ain't never hear no shit like that in a day of my life. Shit, y'all should have let me see it. I said it.
No. Theo tries to get his kids at least once a week.
Yeah.
So how old your oldest son, how young, or oldest child, I'm sorry, and youngest
My oldest son, 16, mm-hmm. 12, 8, 5.
Okay. And you were talking about how one of your sons, one of your sons has special needs, correct? And what... For people that don't have a special needs son, like what would go into that? That would be different than raising, you know, just like.
It's different, but it's not different because he's not on a spectrum to where it's like
mm-hmm.
he can do for himself and stuff like that because he's very independent.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? He makes friends very well. You know,
mm-hmm.
like you know, it's no different, but like with certain things, like his speech development was late.
Mm-hmm.
Because he got Asperger's, so you know, like the way he see things is different
mm-hmm.
than what other people see it. But he's very intelligent,
right?
I think he's my smartest kid. Honestly, I feel like he's been here before.
Shit, don't let the other kids see that.
And listen, man, I'm just keeping it real. I think he's my smartest kid. I feel like he's been here before because some mm-hmm. of the stuff he says, I'm like, yo, kid.
And how old is he?
8.
Okay.
Yeah,
man. Some of the stuff he says is off the wall. So when you hold a conversation with him, it's like you talking to a little adult.
Mm-hmm. I definitely know some kids like that.
Like because you know when I come over there, I try to kitty talk to him. He'd be like, "Nah, dad.
How you doing, sir?"
Like he'd be like, "No, dad. You say I'm a kid, but I'm not a little kid." I'd be like, all right, then, well, I'm going to talk to you like this, man. Get your ass up and clean your room before I fuck you up. Yeah, how about that?
No, kids never want to be called kids or babies. My nieces never want to be called a baby.
Cause I know, because I can't help it. I'm like, man, y'all my babies, bro. Like,
yeah.
Man, I ain't no baby. You know what I mean? Two of my kids taller than me, so they're like, I ain't no baby. So I'm looking up, you are my damn baby.
Bitch.
You came from my nuts. You my baby. Hell wrong with you?
You think any of your kids could beat you up?
Hell no. Hell no. I fuck them up sometimes just to let them know. I ain't got boys.
So do they know you're an artist, like a rapper?
Yeah.
How do they like it? Do they sing your shit?
My 8-year-old dude, like when he want to get on my good side or he wants some Robux or something,
mm-hmm.
he'll come down with his iPad.
Oh, yeah.
And we'll play on one of my songs on his on YouTube and play my video and be like, yeah, dad, what's up? I'm like, what you want? But you know, like, I like my kid, like my 8-year-old, he likes my music, but my other kids, like, they like it, but you know, because I'm their dad, but you know, they have different preferences mm-hmm. in what they listen to. Like, you know, they like the younger generation stuff.
Big facts.
So, you know, I don't, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? I want y'all to be your own person. Think what you want to think. Feel what you want to feel. Like what you want to like. I'm not going to judge you no different. I'm still going to love you.
Right. Right. No, that's what's up, man. I just wanted to know, man. My daughter comes through. She gets hyped. Like, I put some shit on TikTok. I don't know how to work it at all, but I put two videos up there. Anytime I'm around her or she's around, she's just showing people, like, look at my dad video.
That's how my 8-year-old is.
Look at you, man.
My 12-year-old, he did it once for the football team because they messed with me. I came to practice the next day, and they was like, yo, coach, you going to spit some bars for us? I say, nah, I'm tell you what I'm doing. Blow this whistle, y'all going to run some laps.
Oh, shit. Nothing's funnier than making kids run laps.
No.
But the kids, I have to say, man, this was the best coaching kids I ever coached because, like, no matter how much we pushed them, it was with it. It was one time, like, we told them they didn't have to practice. They could have went to their school dance, and all of them said, fuck that school dance. We want to practice because mm-hmm. they know we was going into the playoffs.
Okay.
And, you know, we had number one offense, number one defense. So therefore they knew, like, you know what I mean, everybody gonna be a target on them. Like, everybody gonna be coming for them, playing their best. So they was like, nah, damn that dance. There'll be more dances.
Winning and solves
it,
everything.
Yeah, and it was cold as hell outside. I was hoping they said they wanted to go to the dance. I was hoping.
Fuck the cold. I hate, I always talk about how I want to move up.
You ever play football?
Yeah.
On the team?
Yeah.
Like high school?
Yeah, I was fullback and defensive end.
You do look like James Allstar.
Yeah. We talked about this before. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yo, so I know that the worst, in basketball, the worst thing they could tell you is run suicides until they tell you to stop, right?
Mm-hmm.
The worst thing in
you
football.
You can't even call it that no more.
No. That's crazy.
I learned that.
Mental health awareness run.
Probably.
I learned a lot now by coaching. I learned a lot. Like, you can't say suicides. It's like a lot of stuff. So we had to, you got to switch up the name. You know, I'm old school. So, you know, I'm going to call it what I know. Yeah. What the coaches used to tell me.
Like crabs.
Like crab walk. And
that's
all
what I was
that.
About to say. Did y'all ever have to crab walk the whole field until they tell you to stop?
Hell yeah. What?
We did that an hour.
Bear
one time.
Crawl, all that.
I am the king of bear crawls.
No, I felt I was because
I don't like.
Well, I used to peer them, peer them.
Why do you like
them.
Discipline?
Huh?
You like discipline?
Yeah. Well, I was in the military and stuff, so I'm used
to.
Yeah,
I don't like that shit, bro.
Man, discipline. What am I crab walking for? Discipline is very good.
I'm just a fast bear crawler.
I ain't got no time to be crab walking the whole field for an hour and a half. Fuck this football shit, I'm out.
I gotta go dance with some girls.
No, real shit. That's how I was in high school. I got a job, get my polo boots. You think I'm gonna be hearing you talking to me like that? I could go make my money and, man, fuck this shit.
Man, listen, right in the locker playing room. In Florida because, like, my high school, we didn't have a field, so we had to share the Citrus Bowl. But now, you know, but now it's called the World Stadium,
mm-hmm.
The World Stadium. So it was great. It was a great atmosphere. Like, you know how big that stadium is? Because it used to be UCF home field, but they play all the bowl games there.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, you know, and then you have people in the crowds, and that shit was different. It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I got a rush sometimes.
That was like right. The biggest field you ever played on?
Biggest field I ever played on was University of Penn. I was starting that cornerback and almost had a pick.
Yeah, that was the biggest field I played on.
I played against Andy Reid, son. He was playing quarterback.
Is he as big as Andy Reid was? Andy Reid was huge.
He just was tall. Almost caught a pick off of him, too. That was crazy. But, yeah, playing against – no, we probably lost 7-6. But – I was like, I type of shit. It's Andy Reid, son. Yeah. What's up, bro? Like, yeah, man. I don't like your dad's team, but I fuck with your dad.
He's a Cowboys fan like everyone else in the world.
I know, I'm an Eagles fan.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Sorry to hear that.
I don't know. I'm sorry to hear you a Cowboys fan. How Brady got more playoff wins with the damn Tampa Bay Buccaneers than y'all got since y'all got Super Bowl rings? What can you say about that?
How many rings y'all got?
We got one. We got one, though. Now it went from not having nothing.
With a backup quarterback.
With a backup, too.
And Hurts is about
the... Who fits the system better than the starter did?
Everybody fits better than Wentz, because Wentz is fucking trash.
Nah, I can't say
trash.
That, man.
Wentz ain't trash.
Wentz
lost his offensive coordinator in the middle of his injuries.
Nah, man. I'm going to tell y'all what it was. And you can see it in Wentz play when he was there. That injury mentally did something to him. Because, you know, if you look at how we got to being where we was at when we went to the Super Bowl, it was because of Wentz. His arm and his legs. You know what I'm saying? He stopped using his legs as much and tried to use his arm as more. And it wasn't working
out
for
him. But he's still doing what he did back in 2019 today and still trash.
Well, Jalen Hurts.
But that's
because
he doesn't have... We watch this playoff game. He don't have an arm to save his life.
Man, listen, I love Jalen Hurts.
He threw a pick that should have been a touchdown if he had a fucking arm.
I love Jalen Hurts. Don't get me wrong. You know what I'm saying? But the way that Tampa Bay, they scheduled, they said if he's going to beat us, he's going to beat us with his arm. And he couldn't beat him with an arm. And that was his downfall all season. That's why we was the number one Russian team in the league.
We had the most big plays of any team.
Because we had no fucking choice.
Best Russian, I ain't even going to lie to you. I started respecting that. They started rushing the ball. Jalen Hurts, the only thing that Bibb said it on our episode. Bibb said Jalen Hurts, if he had Carson Wentz's arm, he would be an animal.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And he, what was the other thing he said? Was the baseball player?
I don't think it's arm the problem. I think it's his accuracy.
No, it's but time out. Think about it. Look.
Because you got to think about it. He went to Alabama.
Granted, Tua took his spot.
Yeah, but you can see what he did with Alabama before Tua took his spot. Before Tua took his spot, Alabama was still, he still won championships with them. And you see when Tua got hurt and they put him back in the game and he brought them back in that second half.
So peep this though.
It was with his arm.
You watched the game last week, right?
Yeah.
He threw a pick in the end zone.
Yeah.
It was a curl route. Yeah. It was
Smith. He was open.
Wide the fuck open. The ball came so short.
He was on the run scrambling for his life too, though.
My thing is, if you have an arm, it don't change anything.
Yeah, dude, man, it's easy to throw when your feet set. It's hard to throw on the run.
That means he has to work on that aspect of his game.
No, think about it.
Come on, bro. You just said it, though.
No, his arm, like, you know, you got to work on it, yes. But at the same time, what I'm saying is this. You know what I'm saying? Right, like, why you think they got pocket passers and why you think they got elusive quarterbacks? Like, think about it. Like, for instance.
At the end of the day, Lamar Jackson can make that throw. He's not a pocket quarterback.
Because that's what Lamar Jackson do. Just like Patrick Mahomes. Like, you see some of the throws. Bro.
Starting quarterback, who can't make that throw?
It's a lot of quarterbacks that can't make that throw on the run. He was running.
Give me one.
You gotta understand this. When he threw that ball, he was getting hit too. You know what I'm saying? So that has
I'm not making excuses for your quarterback, bro.
But as a football player, I'm telling you, like, you know what I'm saying? It's easy for us to judge them because we're on the sideline looking in. Until you get in that situation, you would never understand how hard it is to really make that throw. It looks easy to us. But I guarantee you, if you had somebody without no defense right now to go make that curl route and throw it, I guarantee you your throw won't be as accurate as any quarterbacks in the NFL.
You're the starting quarterback for the Philadelphia Eagles. You got somebody wide open. Make the fucking throw. If you're trying to be an elite quarterback in this game, bro, you got to
– He's still young. He's still got a lot to work on.
Yeah, I know. Hopefully he got a spot.
He do. At least they make some trades and get a new quarterback or something, man. Only thing, man, listen. I don't see him going nowhere.
If he had Carson Wentz's arm, he would be MVP caliber quarterback.
Yeah, because he got the speed. You know what I'm saying, my boy?
He got the mindset.
Yeah. But, you know, he don't got his arm. You know what I mean? Like you know what I mean? It's just like... Like, you see some of the throws Patrick Mahomes made?
That's an elite quarterback.
I guarantee you, like, the no-look passes and shit like that, I guarantee you Brady can't do that, and Brady is one of the best quarterbacks in the league.
Brady is the best.
You know what I'm saying?
Brady's a great leader, just like Jalen Hurts. Say I'm wrong. Say Jalen Hurts is not a great leader.
No, he's not as a good of a leader as fucking Tom Brady. Cut it out.
He's an amazing leader. So, are you wondering why I'm dressed this way?
Nah, you told me already.
You know what's about to happen?
Yeah.
We're about to play a game called Plead the Fifth. I'm going to play the intro, and then I'm going to let you know what's up.
One, two.
Please rise. Court is now in session.
The defendant is not guilty.
You're the one who's guilty.
Call the first witness.
I mean,
swear to tell the whole truth, nothing but the truth.
I want the truth. You can't handle the truth.
And the truth.
Just set you free.
And you're just a bunch of lousy, yellow, stinking cowards.
Sir, you're out of order.
Nothing further, Your Honor.
I plead the fifth. No, but I can tell you that I plead the fifth.
One, two, three, four, fifth.
The name of the game is Plead the Fifth. What's going to happen is I'm going to ask you 5 questions. During this time, you can plead the fifth once and only once. If you do plead the fifth, though, you have to chug that whole beer in front of you, homemade best. Should be a sponsor. Homemade is best. Apologies.
I plead the fifth.
Again, there's 5 questions. You can plead the fifth once and only once.
All right.
But if you do, you're going to have to chug that whole beer. Are you ready, sir?
Yeah, I'm ready.
What is the biggest lie you told your kids?
I don't know. I told them a couple of shit.
That you was Santa Claus.
Shit, that was one of them. But that ain't no lie, though. Because I am Santa Claus. But nah, I told my son where babies come from. I told him it came from Target. I said, you got to put a special order in and wait 9 months. And then yeah, I say, he said, but why is it in mommy's stomach? I say, because she had to eat it. So the baby, yeah, I told him. But because I feel like, because his mom was like, don't tell him the truth, because I wanted to tell him.
Was this your first kid?
Nah, this is my 8-year-old. Because okay. He asked.
Yeah.
Like, he asked those types of questions.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, where,
smart.
Yeah, like, where do kids come from?
Right.
And I was like,
I don't know.
because I slipped up and I say that to him too, and it's like he don't get it, but my 12-year-old get it.
That my son ever asked me where kids come from, like, you came from my nuts,
bitch. Question 2. God damn it, Theo, with those fucking Doritos.
You're fucking them up too.
Who was the last woman to text you that was not family, that your girl sitting over there would not like?
Nah, nobody actually.
No, there's no woman.
Nah, not at all.
Sir, you are under oath. There's no.
Nah, I'm telling you, yeah, nah, because you know I'm an asshole. So
girls don't like you.
Yeah, like, cause you know what I mean. I speak my mind. You know what I mean. Like, if I feel some type of way about something, I'm gonna say it. Like, we're adults.
Mm-hmm.
But like, nah, I don't. You know what I'm saying? I don't. I really don't.
You ready for question 3?
Yeah.
Who is the worst rapper you know personally? Shit. Somebody you know personally.
I'm going to have to drink on that one.
That's going
to
be a whole chug. That's the homemade is best.
I don't want to do him like that, man. Because he's my boy, man. But oh, my goodness, man. My boy, I ain't pleading shit, man. My boy, I think he need to hear this anyway. You feel me? I feel like I won't be a real friend.
You gotta stop.
My boy named Simi, you feel me?
Simi?
Yeah. Matter of fact, where my phone at? I'll let you hear it. You feel me? So you know I'm not lying.
What makes him so bad?
You about to hear it. I'm about to
like you or this podcast up there. Make him never be able to get him as a guest.
I'm about to let you hear it. You think I'm making this shit up?
How old is this person?
He's older than me.
Simi.
No, I'm dead serious, yo. I'm not making this shit up.
So excited to hear how bad he is. Do you agree back there? She's not saying anything. I don't want to say your name because you're not on camera.
All right, here we go.
Better not be hot, bro.
I'm telling you, you're going to hear it.
I'm going to tell you about this. Like, this is hot.
That's that nigga teach every word, every word. Tell me in the building, nigga. 4761, stand up.
Stand up, nigga.
You know what it is. You can get the best. Scarface J, all no women, no kids. The black mafia motto is, yeah, how you live. My nigga freshly dropping ice, you know we rockin'. Haters think we stopping, but I'm Batman in Gotham. Rhymes, real stories. Yeah, we bet on Maury. You niggas spit it poorly. One of your
boys. His cadence is not great.
It ain't that bad.
All right, hold on, here we go.
No, it's his worst one. We'll go with that.
Man, what? Man, listen, man.
I agree, man. He did not sound good to the ear.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I just see the good in everybody.
Theo's a producer, by the way. Well, actually, also a rapper, too, so he's both. All right.
Nah, yeah, because, you know, like, I get it. Know what I'm saying, but like,
all right, we heard enough of him. We told him how bad
Justin
he was.
Justin don't want to hear anymore. That's why he's
yeah, because it's just like, listen, man, because I can't explain it. You had to hear it to know why.
His cadence was bad. His voice was bad. Nothing would sound good. Question 4. When is the last time you masturbated in public? Right. Meaning somewhere outside of your house, your car, in a bathroom.
Some wild ass question.
You know,
that's a nut ass question too.
You know, it came literally to your mind.
Nah, it's been a while. You feel me? It's been like a year ago, like one night. Uh-huh. You feel me? I was in my backyard. I had my kids. I couldn't do nothing. You feel me? I ain't gonna lie. You feel me? I was drunk. You know what I mean?
Where were your kids? And where you're in the back?
They were asleep.
Okay. Oh, you were in your backyard?
Yeah, because my backyard, you know what I mean? It's like private kind of.
Is that how you have to jerk off, is the backyard?
I ain't want to do it in the house or the bathroom because I ain't want to get disturbed.
Was it hotter? Is it winter? Is it summer? What is it?
It was cold.
Oh my God. That has, God, damn, you that has to be the most depressing time of your life. Listen, man. That has to be so depressing outside like that.
It was the drugs, man. All right. It wasn't me.
Perfect segue into our fifth question. What is the heaviest or hardest drug you've ever done?
Ecstasy.
Ecstasy is the hardest?
Acid, too.
At the same time?
Yeah. Or, at the same time.
Oh, what is that like? What?
It was amazing, though.
What goes on? I've never done either of them.
Like, well, ecstasy, you know what I mean? It get your hormones raging, you be ready to fuck something. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Acid, like, it opened up my creative side. Like, I did it.
So you were creatively fucking all
like, over? It's visual. It's like a visual thing. Like, mm-hmm. You know, like, if this right here, it'll be coming up. Then, like, it's like crazy. You see the walls breathing.
So you was creatively fucking?
Nah, like, so when like, I did the acid, I was creative.
Put your leg up and let me fuck
you. We was in the studio. My boy was like, yo, I think you should try this and then go in the studio. And I did it, and my goodness, it had me rapping about crazy shit. About people jumping over moons and shit. Like, yo, like, man, listen, man, because you watch TV and you watch certain movies, and it's like the movie that you went and watched sober, you watch it on acid, you'll be like, yo, this is one of the best movies ever.
I've done shrooms, and I watched Horton Hears a Who, and I couldn't get past the intro.
You did shrooms, like acid and shrooms, like the same psychedelics, like, you know what I'm saying? It's in the same family.
Fucked me up. I put on Horton Hears a Who, and have you ever seen Horton Hears a Who?
Yeah.
The wish was going around. It was, have you ever seen Horton Hears a Who?
But it's crazy. You see shit that you wouldn't see when you sober, but when you watching it.
Bro, I got a minute into I thought it was 3 hours. I was like, I can't do this anymore. And I fucking ran out of the room and just...
It was like I was so fucked up. I even jumped in the swimming pool trying to get this shit up off me. I'm like, yo, I am too fucking high.
I feel like that's the exact thing that you want to, like, if something, you got to have a washer.
That's my point of not wanting to fuck with the shrooms and shit and all that, because I don't want to get to the point where I want to come down off the high and I don't have a way to get down.
Yeah, you really can't get shrooms.
Nah, you got to let it go down on its own. And you ain't gonna sleep worth the shit.
No, you ain't, like, no. Like, you're close fucked your eyes up.
If you want to.
That's at least 6 hours off. Oh, fuck, buddy.
Yeah. Well, if you close your eyes.
You're, no matter what, like, but the best feeling in the world is when you're on stuff like that is you lay on a bed, close your eyes, put good music on, and you just sink into the bed.
Yeah.
And you are sand. You are fucking cuckoo ka-choo, bro. You're fucking chilling.
You chill.
Like, oh, there's nothing better in the world, but you got to make sure.
And then if you got somebody, like, you got a girl massage you, rubbing on you and shit, it's the best feeling ever.
But you should have a spotter, though. Fuck. You got to have somebody there who's not going to let you jump into a pool, because that's just crazy. Like, you
know? Nah, the pool, it was the deepest, it was 5 feet, you know what I'm saying? Because we was in an Airbnb. Still,
I want to.
So, if I get on shrooms, I should just get some ass.
You're going to want to.
I tried.
Well, acid, you're going
to
want to.
I tried to jerk off before when I was on shrooms because I was like, I want to have sex. And the girl that was supposed to come over and have sex backed out. And I was on shrooms. And I was like, well, I'm going to try to beat my dick because I want to see what it's like to come on shrooms. And I just kept beating and beating and beating. Nah, and I was like, I'm going to pull my fucking dick off eventually. Nah, I couldn't come.
Once you get on that shit, man.
Yo, why did I segue into that to hear him talk about that? Like,
hey, by the way, you passed Plead the Fifth. Congratulations, sir. You were so close to chugging that beer. I was so excited.
No, nah, because I ain't want to, man. I'm like, man, I can't chug, man. I'm dealing with a hangover, too. I was like, ooh, I had to.
Man, that shit is crazy, man. I do want to try shrooms one time in my lifetime, though, because it's a herb. It's definitely from the grounds. I just don't like the, like, you know, the stories be different from what you, my homies be telling me to fuck with it because my creative.
Yeah, like I'm telling you, like, that's what I thought, because I'm like, when my boy first told me about acid, I'm like, man, nigga, go kill yourself. I ain't fucking with that shit. And then one day he just kept wearing it down on me. So I said, you know what, I'm going to do it. How do you shut the fuck up.
What do you do?
Take a tab, let it sit under your tongue for like 30, 40 seconds, then you swallow it.
Cuckoo ka-choo.
Man, that shit, what? I was like, yo, that was like one of the, it was like one of the best highs ever, though.
But you said that you wanted to get off of it, so you jumped.
Nah, because I've done it more than once, so you know what I'm saying? It's been times where I was like, yo, I am too fucking high, because I know I had to go deal with my kids. Like, I did this shit like a dumbass, knowing I had to get up at 6 o'clock, walk down the street, go get my kids and shit.
Yeah.
Worst thing ever. Because you know when it's coming down and it's wearing off, your body get tired. You be like this. You know what I'm saying? When you wear down off of it, you're gonna want to sleep. You're gonna sleep good. It's gonna be some of the best sleep you ever got.
That's I ain't gonna lie. That's mostly all drugs though. Like especially with weed.
Man, I smoke too much weed. I take a cat nap, wake up, be good.
You be sluggish, bro. I smoke every day, so
I do too. Shit, I got one roll right fucking now.
Yeah.
Do you tell your kids not to smoke?
I tell my kids not to smoke.
Do you smoke in front of them or do they know that you smoke?
They know I smoke because they see the ashtray in the backyard because I don't smoke in the house.
You just jerking off and smoking in the back. That backyard is disgusting.
That was only a one time thing, man. Because they kept getting up fucking with me, fucking with my concentration. So I was in my room. So I'm like, man, you know what, man? Fuck this shit. Because they know when I'm outside, I'm smoking. So they know, don't come outside.
Yeah.
Daddy's out there smoking. They know I don't play that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Is it just you in the house with four kids?
Nah. Me, mom, kids.
Two. You and your two kids?
Yeah.
Do the other two live in Florida or?
One's in Florida, one's in Jersey.
Okay. I thought you lived, okay, so different house in Jersey.
Yeah.
Do you still keep in touch with the, I'm guessing it's your oldest one that lives in Florida?
Yeah, as much as his mom let me.
Okay. You do like a Skype call or like FaceTime kind of thing?
Yeah.
It's gotta be rough though.
No, it's very rough because he's playing football and stuff too.
Mm-hmm.
And it's rough because I'll be wanting to go. Like when I went to Florida, last time I went to Florida, I seen him and stuff, so it was good.
Yeah, that's gotta be fun though, like going all the way to Florida to see your kid.
Yeah, and then I brought his brothers with me, so they was all good.
Mm-hmm. Do they all get along?
Yeah.
How many different baby mamas?
Well, I take that back.
Mm-hmm.
They do get along. It's just my 12-year-old. He don't got no brother unity at all. fucking all, boy, he don't. I'm like, you got an only child syndrome and you ain't the only child. How the hell you gonna have this fucking syndrome?
Nah, he really only has one daughter.
Yeah, my world, Ozzy's world. Mm-hmm. And she a rapper. She really is, though, bro. Her video got like 1,500 views in like 2 days.
See, yeah. Kids be doing better than me on the views. Like, I learned how to use TikTok and shit, man. My 8-year-old. Still
know how to do that shit.
He was like, Dad, put your stuff on TikTok. I said, ow. He said, come here, give me your phone. And he showed me.
Looking at the phone like this, what do I do?
Because I was like, all right. And then he was showing me, he was like, yeah, edit this and do this and do this like that. So, and then you got to download this app. So if you got videos in your phone and you want to play your song in it, you could do this. Like, this my 8-year-old coaching me, telling mm-hmm. me this shit. And I'm like, yo, this technology in this world is crazy. Because, you know, when I was growing up, you know, we stayed outside. Because
mm-hmm.
my mom, you know, grandma's in there, you come in the house, your ass got to stay in. Like, we even drank water out the water hose to avoid going into the house because didn't want to come back, go back in.
It's either in or out.
Yeah. And then, you know, being in Florida, you letting all the goddamn air out my house running in and out.
Yeah. See, we used to walk up and down the creek. Creeks is the way you say it? Is creek the correct pronunciation? Because I know every time I say it, one way.
You say creek.
We would walk up and down the creek, and then we would just drink water out of hoses out of the backyard of people's houses.
It was creek, too.
Yeah, he calls it a creek.
Creek.
Yeah, well, I know one way I say it's wrong.
Because a long time ago, before I started saying milk, I didn't use to say milk, I just say murk.
Murk?
Yeah, because that's how my boys used to say it in Florida, man. We're going to make some murk. I'll be back. Yeah.
Murk don't sound nothing like milk. You know what murk sound like? It's about to fuck your systems up.
At least crick you can understand.
No, we don't know
it's
what
so
is.
Close. Crick.
Crick sound like some crick, shit crick. That crick I don't
sound
want.
Like, sound, like a, like, sound like an insect.
Yeah, it sound like, sound like something I don't want to meet.
Well, that's what we used to do as kids. We walk up and down the creek.
Creek. Say it, man. Say how you want
to
say
it. It's a goddamn creek. Get used to it. Delco, what's up?
Yeah, we know.
We walk up and down the creek, and then if we got thirsty, we just go to someone's hose in the backyard and just drink out of that and then go back in the creek.
Yeah, that's what I used to do. What? I was not going in the house and had to stay in.
Is there a lot of creeks in Florida?
Yeah, a lot of creeks, man-made lakes, all that shit. I almost end up saying, yeah, there's a lot of creeks around.
Theo doesn't believe in creeks.
Crick.
Crick?
I ain't never heard that shit in my life.
Delco. So how long have you been a musician for?
Well, you know, I was doing music when I was younger.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, I got stopped. I got my kids and stuff like that. But then when I got back, well, introduced my boy Callie the Chef.
Mm-hmm.
It was a funny story. They had come to my house to record, and I was talking shit. And they was like, man, you always talking shit like you could rap. You know what? And then I was like, well, you know what? I say, I'm going to tell y'all something. I'm going to do this one time, and then I'm going to go in my room.
Mm-hmm.
He threw on the beat, freestyle, one take, end up keeping it, and made it a song.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was like, you know what? I'm going back. I still got a little bit. So, you know, I'm like, now I'm more financially stable to where I can provide for my music, take care of my kids, and it's not taken out of their mouths. It's not mm-hmm. taken away from my family or nothing like that.
Mm-hmm.
So,
what do you do for, you don't have to say the company or anything, what do you do for like a 9 to 5?
Oh, forklift driver.
Okay, I used to do heavy equipment. Did heavy equipment for like 6 years. I did forklift, grader, dozer. So I've done all of that. So I almost did that when I got home. When I moved back to Philly, I was about to do that, and then I just decided, I was like, I'm sick of being cold, bro.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to be cold ever again.
Yeah, working in the freezer too, so it's cold, dumb cold.
Damn. Yeah, I don't fuck with the cold, bro. Like, my Irish skin cracks so easily. Look, me and Theo were talking about this before, where he was like, I'm ashy. I'm like, bro, Irish skin, like, yeah. My knuckles are bleeding. They're not shedding skin. They're bleeding during the winter. It's terrible. So what do you think, Theo, you can attest to this too. What do you think, what's the difference between someone like somebody who works a 9 to 5's brain and someone who wants to be like a musician or producer? Like, what differentiates?
Well, I don't think nothing.
I don't think nothing different. Yeah, nothing because you know, you even got the though,
same mindset.
Even though you know, you want to be a producer and stuff like that, you know, we still have to be realist. You know what I mean? Like, it ain't paying the bills right now. It ain't doing that, so we still have to go out
mm-hmm. now. If you
ask, and provide.
If you ask the question of, not just pointing out that specific thing, being an artist or a musical, if you saying what's the difference between going to a 9 to 5 and being an entrepreneur, then it's a whole different ball game.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning that it's kind of the same mindset, but with an entrepreneur, it is you getting out every day and you're doing all the groundwork. So instead of you going to a 9 to 5 and working for somebody else to tell you, you making the rules and you got to abide by the same rules you put there,
mm-hmm.
and you can't bullshit. So if you get up 7 o'clock to go to your job every day, you got to get up 7 o'clock and work on that business or whatever you're doing every day. And you got to give it the same energy. So if you was going to stay to work from 9 to 5, you was going to stay for a double, that means put that double in as an entrepreneur. Musical artist, it's a little bit different.
Yeah.
Because you can take your time, you can still have a 9 to 5 and do that. So, because that just funds it. Now, when you say the entrepreneurship, that's when it gets different, because that means you're taking a whole 9 to 5. You're leaving a 9 to 5 to make it your business, the 9 to 5.
Yeah.
So you're a musician and a producer. Do you change, like, are you different in a producer setting, like how you act, than you would in like when you're actually being a rapper, a hip hop artist?
Yes and no. So as an artist, being an artist, that means I'm solely focused on myself in that moment.
Mm-hmm.
I'm solely focused on me. It's all about me. I'm coming into the beats. I'm rapping this and that. When I'm being a producer, it's not too much about me.
Mm-hmm.
It's about getting the best record or the best sound out of this artist that I'm working with.
Mm-hmm.
How to take him to the next level. It's not about me. It's mm-hmm. about making him the best thing. For real, like, I'm not looking for the credit to make him the best. I just want to see it happen mm-hmm. at that moment. So, you know what I mean, it's a difference between being an artist, because being an artist is when you're being selfish more so. How I could put it is, you're being selfish, being an artist, being a producer, you're being selfless.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
It sounds like you're almost describing a mentor. Like, you're more of a mentor as a producer than a musician.
Yeah, because you got to dig it. When people come to you as a...
it's like that. You have to... Sometimes you have to be like that. Like, with my bro Audio that was on the podcast with me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you feel me? He didn't know me from nothing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I was rough around the edges. But he took that time out. He takes the time out in the day and he works with me. And he mm-hmm. gets me right. And he tell me what I should do and what I shouldn't do. You know what I mean? Because some producers really don't care. If you paying for the beat, they don't give a damn what you do. They'll do it, mix it, bam, I got my money for it.
Mm-hmm. Yo, so it's more so like he was just saying, though, it's more so like a, like, just imagine a teacher tutoring,
mm-hmm.
right? So it's all about, like, little shit for me. Like, being a producer for me, it'd be the smallest shit, like taking a word out. Instead of saying N, say A. Instead of saying the, say two. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's just the smallest shit about fitting, making the song the best song it could be. Don't say this like this, say this like that. And like you said, your man help you out. Yo, some artists just need that one little, yo, you're too wordy. Let's limit the words.
Yeah, that's what he tells me. Yeah, because, you know,
I can get it when you said that.
Because I be trying to, you know what I mean, like, it sound good in my head. So then when I start writing it down and shit like that, then when I go in there and spit it, and sometimes, you know, you get in there, you be, hold on, let me do it again. He be like, he'll come and be like, stop. Instead of saying that, why don't you use a simpler word that means the same fucking thing? Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying?
So do you guys think, with all that, do you guys think that the best producer is also a musician who's been doing it a while? Or do you think just being a producer their whole life is better?
I can't say either.
It depends on what they've been through. You know what I'm saying? What they know, what the knowledge is, what they took up. You know what I mean? Because it's a lot of good producers. It's some producers you'll know that's not even mainstream, that's better than some of the mainstream people.
Yeah,
but it's because, you know, you don't have the right people behind you, or you haven't found that right foot into the door, or that right person didn't hear you or see you. You know what I mean? You'll never know.
Don't get it fucked up though, because it's a dude that can been a musician for 20 years, and it's somebody that could had just picked it up, but they already had the potential and talent that you never knew. They could just pick that up, and you show them one thing, and he was only doing it for a year. You show them one thing. And them just learning that one thing of their tapped in potential that they already have can skyrocket before that guy in 20 years. Just because he knows, like, you know what I'm saying? Some people are just gifted.
Like Iguodala. He started playing basketball in what? High school? Like senior year?
Say Joel Embiid. What? That's a better. No, when I say that is what I'm saying is, Joel Embiid picked up the game late.
Yeah.
Later than most people.
Yeah. Just like Jason Pierre-Paul did too.
Exactly. Yeah. He's an MVP candidate. Mm-hmm. Now, granted, fuck your head up. Pascal Siakam.
Yeah.
Picked the game up late, but he's not an MVP caliber player. You see how some people just have that natural to be that good.
Rodgers started football in high school. Like, he started freshman year, so
people Michael been Jordan, for example, high school, he wasn't even the man.
Yeah.
He didn't make varsity to like a junior or senior.
So what, as a coach, what do you look for that would differentiate someone between being a lineman and being a running back? Like, if you see somebody outgoing, are they automatically put into a position of like importance, or is it more of what they show in practice?
It's what they show in practice and their abilities too, because, you know, being a coach, the job is, you know, you don't want to push them away from their dreams and their goals, but, you know, you got to try to teach them what you know, the knowledge of the game, too. Mm-hmm. And by that, it's just hard because, you know, man, you know, you tell a kid they want to play running back, but then, you know what I mean, he might not have the ability to do that. You know what I mean? Like, for instance, like this man, like, say if he wanted to play line, but, you know, his size – And it's not going to do it because, you know, you got big-ass people on the line. Like, you know, line is made for big people. That's what you getting in the trenches.
I'm brolic, bro.
Okay.
You're what?
I'm brolic.
You could be brolic. You could be brolic at heart. Scrappy? You feel me? You could be brolic at heart.
I've never heard brolic before. Does that mean scrappy?
Nah, that means he's big.
Like big. You never heard brolic before?
I've never heard brolic.
Muscle, like he muscle bound.
Yeah, like
he
what's wrong with him, man?
Me?
Disrespecting my brolicness.
Man, I think you just made up the word.
I could dig it, but I guarantee you right now, me and you, no matter how much brolic we say, we'll be going in front of them damn NFL linemen, and they're going to show us who brolic.
Who even go?
All right, then.
I'm not going. Yeah, shit. I might talk that shit and get in front of him. Come on, man.
No, I was just kidding.
Come on, man. I say the bear.
But nah, man, like, it's when just a shroom? It's just like, but with this team, I didn't really have to worry about that because everybody knew their position and knew what they were supposed to be playing at.
What? How old are they?
11 and 12.
Okay, so they've already been playing together for a while.
Yeah, they've already been playing together for a while. This is me and my son first year out. Mm-hmm. Both of my kids first year.
When I was in elementary school and middle school, I was a receiver and I can catch. For some reason, when I got to high school, couldn't catch to save my life. And then I was just bigger, so they put me in fullback.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened. Like, somehow, I just couldn't catch anymore.
I don't think you ever could catch.
What?
It was probably the competition, too.
Man, he's talking about his creative player. Man. Oh, shit. He can never catch anything.
Damn, he's trying to say my man got the hands.
You know what?
Stone.
I have something to say, but I have to pee, actually.
That's the only thing about the catch. So his dick in his hand.
Yo, that's
he is
crazy.
Crazy, man. Listen, man. Like I said, bro. I'm brolic.
I can dig it.
I am motherfucking brolic. Dio Doce the brolic, motherfucker. And if you're too big and you talk shit to me, my gun is brolic too.
Facts.
Yeah, man. So what's up, man? What you got coming, man? You got some new music for me?
Yeah, man. I got new music. I'm releasing an album like the next week and a half.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, EP, 8 songs. It's called The Beginning. Yeah.
You got a single first?
Yeah.
Got some I got
videos? 2 singles. Nah, I'm working on the videos now. I'm doing the cover art.
Talk to me, you know what I'm saying? You need cover art. You need all that type shit. Talk to me, man.
Yeah, because my cousin, I am going to need it, but my cousin just blessed me this time because he's going to do some cover art for me because he go to school in Atlanta, Georgia for making videos, for doing videos and stuff. Like, he's from Jersey, he's from Somerset, but he moved to Atlanta because he go to school out there for it. So he going to do it for me. But yeah, man, like, we definitely need that, you know. You can't never get enough of cover art. Different people, different designs, different shit, you know.
That's my actual graphic designer right there.
This is the guy that I've heard about but never seen and never.
Yeah, he always bullshitting. Call him out. His name Mozzie fucking Cobby.
He has a big-ass afro.
Matter of fact, come here.
Come and tell me the reason that you're not helping me out. My feelings are hurt all the time.
Come on and join right here. Hey, yo, what's that basketball player from the Pistons?
Yeah.
Ben Wallace.
Oh, I was going to say, you're talking about Ben Wallace, bro?
Ben Wallace, bro. You feel me?
Tell him your name.
And tell the reason why you haven't been my best friend.
Nah, they put you on the spot,
Nah, we could be best friends, bro. No, I just...
What's your reason?
What happened? This man say he got
Wait, is this the guy life, that you always say is going to come and then never comes here? Yep. This fucking guy.
Man say he got a busy
Grows
life,
an afro
man.
And suddenly.
Schedule busy, man.
When you were in elementary school, did you have that afro?
Nah, I just had a curly top. Small.
How long have you been growing that afro for?
Since 2014.
And it's longer than what you think. It's just, it's curly right now. If you get a fucking pick or something, pick it up.
Does your mom hate it or does she love it?
Yeah, she hates it.
She's like, why would you're you never gonna get a job like that?
Look like a presentable young man.
I got enough jobs.
Well,
so
tell him we're not looking for jobs no more.
Nah,
I'm trying to be my own boss, man. I'm tired of making the money and they giving me fucking pennies.
I'm not filling out no more job applications. I'm not going to take no more drug tests because, yes, it's marijuana in my system.
And it's legal now.
Yeah. I'm not taking no more drug tests. I'm not going through the bullshit no more. The assessment questions is too many questions in 3 minutes. I don't got time for
it. I know, asking me the same shit in different words.
Yeah.
Say
it again.
Like, Billy jumped over the bridge.
Like, I'ma say.
And then Mike went and did this and then you know, like, I'm saying hold on, like, bro. Y'all asked me the same question 5 times in different ways,
if
bro.
If you see Jimmy still in a Snickers bar, what would you do?
Mind my
Let
fucking
Jimmy's
business.
Take the Snickers bar. Get me a Reese's while you at it, Jimmy.
I'm gonna turn the other way. I ain't see Jimmy do shit. I'm mind my fucking business. Don't ask me shit.
It'd be like A, B, C, D. Where E at? Mind my motherfucking business. Like, I ain't got no time for it. But yeah, this is Cobby, the bullshitter. This is my little bro.
That's a good word for him, bullshitter.
I'm gonna
get my own episode.
Yeah, I know, right? They hard.
Yeah, you're gonna get your own episode. We all believe it. We all believe that you'll be here at 1 o'clock on a Sunday.
Yo, they hard on you, bro. Ain't
it? Yeah,
it's hard for me to get here at 1 o'clock on a Sunday. You talking about him?
I'm gonna get my episode.
3 o'clock.
It's 3 o'clock.
Gotta do push-ups. Go ahead.
Yeah, I got you. 25.
Go ahead. I want to see you do it. Every time we have a podcast, he does his alarm goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Extend 8, 9.
He got his brolicness.
11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. I don't think he's actually 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. That's it, 26.
actually did like 29. You started late as shit.
No, he's just making things up.
Look. Run that shit back. Look at all. I am tired as fuck.
I know you is. I'm tired looking at your ass doing the push-up shit.
I wore a flannel today.
Look at all mad.
He brolic and try to lose weight at the same time.
Hey, so what's the pettiest reason you guys have ever gotten mad about something?
Oh man, I'm petty. I'm letting you know I'm a petty ass motherfucker, boy.
What's the pettiest reason?
I am petty.
With a D.
I am petty. What? You can't do shit to me and piss me off. I do some shit on purpose just to piss you off.
Damn, you really that petty?
Yeah.
To your females or just friends?
Period.
I'll tell you right now, Love City Brewing, go fuck yourself. Keep going, sorry.
Hell yeah, man. Listen, man, I'm petty, bro. Like, listen, you can't do no shit to me. I'm petty as fuck, yes, because I want you to feel the way I felt when you did it. So I'm petty as hell. And see, if I it don't work, I am.
Shit, I ain't petty like
I'm
that.
I'm petty and I can fight, so Tom. Fuck.
I'm fucking petty, bro.
That's always a good thing. I'm petty and I'll fuck you up.
I'm petty and I can fight. What you want to do? It's no secret.
But you never got mad off of something petty?
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, I've been petty to women. You know what I'm saying? But like,
them too, what?
Homies, I ain't gonna lie.
All the time, bitches stood me up. You feel me? I'm petty as a motherfucker.
See, I am
petty. I go out my way before you can see me.
I don't forget. I don't forget. Fuck you.
I don't forget. But petty, like, to like homies or like dudes, I ain't got time. That's a lot for me. That's too much energy exuded for me to be petty towards you. Like, coming into the same room and just not speaking to you and shit. Like, man, fuck that nigga.
No. Like, I'm not petty like that. Like, I speak to you, but I'm petty. Like, I speak to you and then say some sideways shit. You're right there to your face. You feel me?
I'd be like,
what's up, bro? But I'd be like, you a fuck nigga. You know that? I just want you to know. Like, yeah, I'd be like, what's up, bro? But I just want you to know you a bitch ass nigga. Now what?
You know what I'm saying?
So you shake people's hands, be like, what's up, bro?
Yeah. And I'm still shaking his hand. He look right in my face. And I'd be, I say something. I'd be like, this, man, you dirty motherfucker. Like, yeah.
So I think we should get into the bitches be crazy.
This is like this McDonald's in Jersey.
Got your back, Jack. Bitches be crazy.
Is that a little kid right there?
Bitches be crazy.
Yo, you seen the one when the lady threw the blender?
Got your back, Jack.
Goddamn blender thing at the lady. Fucked her shit up.
Mm-hmm. I ain't see that one.
She threw the food back at her because she waited in the drive through for 25 minutes. Right, so you want to throw food through the fucking blender? Hit her and her shit. She fell and slid across the floor. I was like, damn, she got an arm.
So we had to watch a lady go crazy inside of McDonald's over $3. Talk about petty wop. With her kids there.
With the kid in the back. That's gangster.
For
$3? Fuck that. Over $3 motherfucking dollars. Now break this
bitch. That's right.
What's wrong with you? Don't talk all that shit through drive-through. Bitch, you make
kids are crying.
Sad. Look at the kid, man.
I know, right? She cried because she can't get McDonald's. Oh, I feel bad.
Tear this bitch up.
The stimulus ain't coming in no more, man.
With me. I will break all this shit.
Oh,
yeah, she's getting locked up.
$3 a night! $3 a night, bitch! Fuck wrong with you?
Damn, she's going crazy, ain't it?
She needs a hug.
I'm not hugging her crazy ass.
I think she's had too much dick for her.
No.
Somebody look, that crazy with kids, she's had too much dick.
She don't have enough.
No, she got four. She had four kids.
I understand that. Nobody's fucking her no more. Yeah, exactly.
That's why, because she's crazy.
No, that's why she's crazy, because she's backed up.
I guarantee you hear her. She'll come in here be trying to do that same shit. Oh, you don't want to return my
fuck, she's jogging and shit. Like,
look, if she get mad over $3, just imagine if you don't call her back, what she gonna do? Shit, fuck no. Keep that crazy bitch away. That crazy bitch out there, Day Day.
Oh. I would not. Look how big her hoops are. Don't fuck with somebody that big of hoops. She kicks. Up.
Going down. Oh, she said that calm. Going down.
She's like, oh shit. They're making $7.25 an hour. Like, it's not worth it. That's what they're making an hour, $3 at McDonald's.
Don't talk shit to her when she walking out the door. When she was walking in the door.
$3 over some food. Is you dumb or not? Is you dumb or are you stupid?
This poor guy has to clean it up. Look at all this shit. He's like, God damn it, I gotta pick up the buns. Look at the poor guy.
And they still gonna sell all that shit. They still gonna sell all that shit.
She done lost her damn mind, boy. Yes, she did.
Now, would you get mad over $3?
No.
Nah. But what could have possibly happened at McDonald's for $3?
Something else triggered that. That $3 was just something she could say.
It might have been her last, though. You feel me? You never know. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? People, honestly, people act crazy about their last. You know what I'm saying? You don't know her financial situation or nothing. You feel me? Like,
but whose side do you take? So
I don't take nobody's side. Like, she's wrong as hell because, you feel me, you can't go in there acting like that, not in front of the kids.
Well, let's say
you know what I'm saying?
Let's say there's a cashier who she thinks shorted her $3. And the cashier says, no, I didn't. Before the fight happens, whose side are you going to take?
Shit.
Customer's always right in those situations, but, you know, in her situation.
Yeah, her job is to prove to her that she didn't. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That's what they make receipts and shit for. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And they put on the receipt what you paid, what you used to pay. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So if you paid with 20, it'd be like, you paid with 20, change this. You know what I'm saying?
Well, on my receipt at Walmart, it said I paid for 4 items, and I had 13.
Light skinned guys get away with shit, huh?
Nah, anybody get away.
My boy double scared. He did like this.
No. It's like this. It's deep.
You feel me? Yeah.
That's in there too. You know what I mean? Self checkout is a motherfucker. And Wawa just got self checkouts in certain ones.
Let me tell you, I seen somebody on Walmart. This nigga was raw. This nigga took the price tag off some shit and put it on like some socks and drawers. He put a $1 price tag on that shit and went through the fucking self checkout, scared the shit, and paid $2 for some socks and drawers and walked right out the store. He was like, "Have a good day, sir." I'm sitting there sweating balls because I'm like, I got all this fucking money in my pocket.
I'm gonna keep it at 100.
I'm like, I hope they don't come to the door. I'm gonna be sick. I'm like, I ain't had shit to do with it.
If I'm at the door at Walmart and I'm the nigga that check your receipt when you go out, and I look at your receipt and it says 5 things, and I look at your bags and there's 7 of them. Damn, bro, next time let me know what you get. Let me get my shit too. Like, I don't give a fuck, man. I don't know how you could. Would you let somebody go if you know they took too much?
They gonna be mad at me at the
keep
door.
Keep it 100. Keep it 100. No. Would you stop them and be like, come on, bro, I seen that.
Yeah.
Not me. See me.
See, you'll be fighting him. Like, get the fuck out of here.
See me. If I'm at the door, you can be mad at me. I'm checking every fucking thing off. I don't give a fuck. I ain't looking at it. Go ahead. You good. Go ahead. You good.
Yeah.
Go ahead,
you good. Go.
Depends how obvious it is. If it's something that it's like you have a TV in your cart, and I'm like, dude, come on, bro. How am I supposed to let you go?
In reality, if you look at the joint, if you look at his
receipt,
and it says $66, and it's a 70-inch in your cart.
Nah, you got to say something.
Bro.
Your job going to be on the line.
Bro.
Like, bro, could you have, like, took it, like,
toilet paper? Bro, I'm going to have to quit. I'm going to have to quit, bro. Like, go get me one.
Hell nah.
Real shit. I'm going to hold this one while you go get the other one. That'd be the day I throw my vest down. I quit. And then with the 70-inch on my way home.
Hey, that's, if you're working at Walmart, a 70-inch TV is definitely worth your job.
Yeah, facts.
Yeah, definitely. McDonald's, nothing there is worth any money.
But they say, man, you know, they're up in the pay. People at McDonald's making $15 an hour
Not yet.
Nah, in Jersey.
Not yet, bro. I ain't even gonna lie to you. I work over Jersey too. When I try to go to work.
Nah, my bro at the McDonald's, he just hired him.
They just like him.
They didn't be paying him $15.
They just like him. Because only people I know that went up to that, like, and actually sticking to it at the moment is Walmart. Walmart and Chick-fil-A actually start off high like that.
Amazon's pretty high.
Yeah, well, Amazon's a different type of company. Different.
I would never work for they. I got offered a manager position there, but it was like the way they work. My girl used to work there. Ash used to work there. She said, "You do not want to work for them because you do not." I mean, I don't care about moving, but for 12 hours a day, fuck that.
Well, I was a mailman.
But $20 an hour, shit.
Well, I was a mailman and I worked for FedEx. Mm-hmm. I like being by myself. I like those 10 to 12 hour shifts to myself. I could work on music. I could do whatever I want. I could talk on the phone.
Yeah.
I'm moving at my own pace. I love those jobs. Amazon was a little different. When I went to get hired, I failed the drug test.
You did too?
I always do, bro. I ain't even gonna lie to you.
Once they did it, I told the dude, he was like, yo, you got the job. You just gotta pass the drug test. I said, you know what? I'm not even gonna waste my time or your time. I'm gonna fail this bitch.
No, like, and
he
crazy.
Was like, you know what? You're like one of the first people that actually did it. I'm like, man, I ain't gonna let you waste your time. I'm gonna fail it, bro.
Yeah.
I'm high now.
That's the only reason I can talk to you right now.
Yo, the thing about it is, and then motherfuckers are trying to tell you, like, I got drug tests. Everybody have every fucking remedy for you in the world, and none of them motherfuckers work.
None of that shit like, works.
One time I took these niacin pills, bro. The one of the worst experiences of my fucking life, bro.
Realize, like, when you take it, you can't take the shit and then smoke right after you take
it. No, you ever took niacin pills?
Yeah, man. I had my tattoos all itchy and swollen.
Bro,
shit.
This is the worst feeling in the history of feelings. Like, my whole body just felt like it was, like, on fire, itching.
It, for real.
Under your skin.
Skin be all hot and
you'll
shit.
Be like, yo. Like, I'm talking about, I was getting.
And then you got to piss like a motherfucker,
bro, I took my towel, turned the shower on, and put my towel in, on the floor in the towel and let it soak and, like, wrung it out and then laid on it. Because, like, I couldn't, like, yo, the shit. And then when it got down to my ankles and feet was the worst.
It was the fucking
that worst. Whole day, I said I would never take these pills ever again in my lifetime. Felt like I was dying. I ain't even drink the second one yet, man. Before we leave, we got to chug one of these joints.
I can't chug shit.
No, you got to be a man.
Man, listen,
you a
bro.
Man? You said you play football.
Yeah, listen, man. I mixed Hennessy with moonshine last night. Fuck you talking about? Man, I am a man. I'm here, ain't
sure,
I?
You got, sure you ain't got a kid on the way?
Nah, because, man, I went home. I fell asleep on the fucking floor, bro. My jacket on
Hennessy
and everything.
And
only thing
moonshine.
I had on was the shoes.
Hennessy and moonshine.
It wasn't even real moonshine.
You look like you was ready
to
go
like
to the war.
It was like 1800, but you feel me? But you
saying
know,
you
we,
to Iraq.
We ran out of Hennessy. We was at the Beast on the Beat. So, you feel me? The vendors there were selling liquor, so, you know, I had to take what was there. And started drinking that shit. We good. We get to the studio, about to record. Everybody like, yo, And then once I got home, you feel me? Mm-hmm. I started feeling it. I'm on the side of the house like, oh, shit, so I'm not going to make it. So, I made it to the living room.
Yeah.
I know. I remember I took my shoes off, and that was it. Cause after I took off my shoes, I woke up this morning in my jacket, this heavy ass jacket, and the clothes I had on last night, sweating like a motherfucker.
Yeah, if you wake up in your jacket, you know you're fucked up.
My son woke me up, we're gonna pull my fucking eyelids, like we're talking about I'm home.
So, Bodum, in the past and the future, this is because you've been rapping for a while in the past, and now you are in the future still rapping, still doing your thing.
Yeah,
should be a sponsor, by the way. So, if you had a musician that you could work with, who's, like, your dream to work with?
Dio Doce.
Present company excluded, of course.
Okay, I'm sorry.
You have a musician to work with. Who's yours? Theo as well. You guys both get on this. If it's Jay-Z, you can leave.
Nah. Honestly, man, it's a couple of people I would love to work with. Like, Jadakiss is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I would love to do a song with Jadakiss. I would love to do a song with J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, Lil Baby. You know what I mean?
Who do you think you would have, like, the best song with? Like, you're putting out a song.
Honestly, the reason I'm going to say, I say Lil Baby because, you feel me? And the reason I say that is not to take nothing away from Jadakiss and none of them.
Mm-hmm.
But Lil Baby, you got a song with Lil Baby, that bit going to pop everywhere.
I don't even know.
You know
what's
what
a song
saying?
About Lil? I don't even know who Lil Baby is.
No.
Name a song by him.
Bert. You know everybody's shit.
I'm just saying, everybody. This how you do it. You just type in Lil Baby, and the first song that come up is going. Matter of fact, he did the what's the joint for the
with
for
Drake
the world?
Too.
He had a song go Goo Goo Gaga.
Nah, he did a song for the world and everything.
Yeah. Never been talking music. Nah, man, you wouldn't even know that joint.
You gotta play. All right,
Theo, how about you?
You gotta play some shit they play on the radio.
Theo, how about you? Musician you wanna work
that
with?
That shit with him and Drake and Lil Durk, or him and Lil Durk.
See, to me, that sounds like every musician since like 2018.
That's my dog. You ever heard? That's my dog. That's my dog for sure. That's my dog. Dog for sure.
Yeah, there's one too.
That sounds familiar then. I won't
742 duck. Fuck that dog like that.
Hat.
Can I dance? Can I dance too? Is this cool? Am I doing it good? If I do the disco, is that still cool? You're doing the rope. You're doing like a rodeo. You're like a cowboy. Yes. He's got the rodeo cowboy going on with the plaid shirt. I didn't know you were a country boy.
You know, I'm not a country hoes.
Hold on. You go to one country bar. When I lived in Vegas, bro, there's country bars all over the place. Like, there's girls at, like, you know, you go to a biker bar, you go to a club. But when you go to a country bar, the girls there. I have a girlfriend now. I love her to death. But holy shit.
Yes.
Never let me in a country bar.
Yeah, wow,
make sure I do not go. No matter how drunk
don't
I am.
Judge me. I'm about to tell you. I'll never forget it. My boy Robbie, JJ, they took me to this shit in Orlando. It's called Cowboys. But yo, oh my fucking goodness.
Girls that go to country bars are a different type of person. Like, Theo's. What's going on, Theo?
I had to put my hood on.
Cowboys, yo, that shit was lit.
Dude, country bars are so much.
I thought you was hating just now.
That's the name of the bar. You know what I mean? That's the name of the country bar.
Stop being a hater.
They different. They different than that motherfucker.
And the dances are so easy. I could figure out when I was drunk. I could hook up. Like, you could hook up with anyone there.
I ain't do none of the dances. I was just playing the wall. Yeah. But you feel me? Yo, it didn't matter.
You start as a wall, but everyone brings you in.
And then I was the only black guy there.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, Florida, I'm about to get fucked up in here. No, they embraced me.
Yeah, you're the only black guy here. Everyone wants to meet you.
I went back. And then this second time I went back, I had cowboy boots. I had the fucking hat.
Yo, cowboy boots are so comfortable.
Nah, my boys,
you had the Wrangler jeans.
I had the whole
thing. So you had your jeans tucked into your boots.
I had the flannel one with the tucked in, you feel me?
He fucked one white girl and said, I'm getting Wranglers tonight, boys.
No. They told me to come back. I went back with my boys and I dressed up with them. Oh my fucking goodness.
You a different type of breed. Was you talking like them?
Nah, you feel me?
I pick up accents real fast. I call for Chinese food. Hello. Like, right, like almost immediately, my accent changes.
Yeah. I ain't never heard that shit before a day in my life. You said hero.
Hero.
Hero. What you order when you call him?
Chen Wayne.
Puff her eyes.
We don't take a cot.
I'll order food from everywhere.
Cash only.
You're looking like you're still. Hurry up and buy.
Wait, Theo, what was yours? You're a musician you can work with. We got a little baby.
Esco.
Nah, that's my guy. Too, nah. Man.
If I could work with Nas.
It's so many of them that I will feel like I will feel good.
But if we're talking about, so that's older. Nas and Kiss is like Nas, Kiss, and Lauren. I put them three. But if we're talking about newer generation of artists and shit, it would be Cole, it would be Kendrick, it would be Drake, and it would be like Lil Baby. Like Lil Baby is somebody I would love to. I would love to tap in with Roddy Ricch, but the only thing about Roddy Ricch is like the new shit he put out is like falling off. But he's such a creative mind. And Young Thug, ooh, let me get in the studio with Young Thug. That shit'd be crazy. Oh, fuck all the shenanigans. I don't know what he into. He be calling his guns dicks and shit. That's wild.
Sounds like a friend.
You.
I don't know what the hell, man.
Yeah,
this,
but you
this
mean,
generation crazy, man. Like they get mad at niggas. They talk shit about you eating a hot dog. Like, nigga, I was grew up and my cookouts and family, nigga, if you wasn't a certain age, you wasn't going over there to the grown people table eating ribs and shit. We had to eat motherfucking hamburger, hot dog, beans, you feel me, and the 25-cent juices in a fucking cooler.
The Huggies were the greatest thing.
That's cause kids Huggies waste, are kid. That's cause kids waste everything. You give a kid.
Yeah, they do, really.
And that's what my people was on. They was like, man, what? And the motherfuckers now, they tell you gay because you're eating a fucking hot dog.
Think about it.
How the fuck you gay for eating a fucking hot dog? You tripping.
How many kids' birthday parties y'all been to?
Hello.
All right, so peep this.
Hamburgers, hot dogs.
Hamburgers, hot dogs, and pizza is always like a go-to, right?
Yeah.
How many plates by the end of the day you cleaning up and it'd be two bites off of each slice of pizza on every plate?
It's the same thing.
With a half of juice and then the kid going over there, the same kid going over there to get another juice in his joint. You don't drink this motherfucking juice, man. I'm going to put my flesh up your ass.
They'd be full off.
Throwing up shoestrings.
We took our nieces to Texas Roadhouse yesterday. They took two bites.
Wildin'.
And Texas, you know, Texas Roadhouse, that place, they mess up everything on our order, by the way. I'm not going to get into it because it's just going to piss me off. But the kids do not eat shit. We got them chicken nuggets and macaroni and cheese. How hard is it to eat a chicken nugget and macaroni and cheese? Two bites.
Be pressed about it, but they eat all your shit.
Oh yeah.
What? My daughter be tearing my shit up.
I can't have shit.
You have
shit. That's why kids, you can't order, have shit.
I order two meals. One that she sees me eat, and the other one.
I got my snacks. I try to hide them under the bed. Oh, that shit don't work.
I got a story for y'all.
I go in my son's room, make him clean his room. I'm like, hold on, my nigga. Look like, that's the shit I was looking for the other night when I was high as hell, got the munchies. I go in his room, nigga, all in there. I'm like,
peep this one.
Can't have shit with kids, man. Kids eat all your shit.
I'm sleeping on the couch. My daughter outside playing with the little girls on the block. She come in the house. I'm on the couch. Daddy, daddy, daddy. I get a fruit snack. Go ahead. Cool. Boom. I'm knocked the fuck out. The box still there. Ain't shit in the box. She took everything out the box and gave it to everybody on the block.
My mom hate that shit. Yo, I used to get my grandma.
Go knock on their door and tell their mom I need my shit.
If I did that with my grandma, man, my grandma will fuck me up. You think I'm feeding the community around that bitch?
Bloop, I was bloop, so bloop, hot. Bloop, bloop. Because I was at like a Whole Foods.
Yeah.
And I got those type fruit snacks from Whole Foods. Shit. They like good joints. It was a little expensive. So, and it was only six in a pack.
Oh, yeah.
And there's only three of y'all. So what you gave them? Y'all had two apiece.
They had two apiece.
My mom
little
used to.
Little ass packs, one ain't doing enough.
Why the fuck did you take all my fruit snacks out?
Two things. All right, first.
And left the box in there.
Fruit snacks, one, is the best way to categorize the food because everyone thinks it's healthy, which it's not. Two, my mom used to give us the most expired food that has ever existed. I ate a Rice Krispie. I had to go out. My house was where all our friends would go. I went out. We had a trampoline too. I went out with a trampoline full of friends with a box full of Rice Krispie treats that were hard as this fucking wall. I was like, oh, they're good. They're good. They're good. I had to sell it. I went back in. I looked at expiration date. It was like 3 years expired. You know how long it takes for a fucking Rice Krispie treat to expire? Like 2 or 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
I had people eating expired Rice Krispie treats from years ago.
I had some expired food in my life. Well, maybe like 2 months ago, I ain't even paying attention. I made like a couple sandwiches, and I knocked off the first one. And when I looked at the second one, like I think it was like turkey burgers or something. When I looked at the second one, the bread was molded. And I was like, did I knock off that first sandwich? This molded bread? Like, was that just the taste in that joint?
I remember I was so fucking drunk and I wanted some cereal.
Can you move closer to the mic? Sorry, we can't.
I was so drunk, I wanted some fucking cereal. The milk was bad.
Milk, dairy goes bad. When it goes bad, you see the expiration date, that's the real shit. Like, don't fuck around with a day or two afterwards because you're going to be fucked up.
Nah, that's what I did.
I ain't drink regular milk in a couple years.
And I paid for it too. That shit had me on the toilet. It sounded like a helicopter lifting off in that motherfucker.
Yo, he's the one that clogged the toilets, man.
Yeah, what? Yes, I like to eat shit.
But guys,
when I'm hungry, I like to eat.
How many? If I take
not
a poop,
even that big, bro.
If I take a poop, that's the best thing you've ever said to me. Normally, you call me fat. I get nothing but mean words thrown my way.
I'm
from
275 pounds.
Nah, cut it out. Stand up real quick.
Fix the shirt.
All right, you may be 240.
No, I'm 275. I went to the doctor last week.
Wait, you're 275, so I'm like 210. What do they say to you when you're 275? Do they go, you know what?
Nah, because the doctor was like, you don't even look that big.
Yeah, you don't.
You know what I'm saying?
But solid, do you have one of those hard bellies?
Yes.
I got a hard belly,
man,
too.
My shit hard as hell.
You got like muscle in there, but it's like.
Yeah, shit.
I told him, man, muscle got memory, man. I lose this shit.
Oh, that's what muscle memory look like?
Nah.
I don't want it.
It's hard, but if I lose this shit, my pack could come back. You know what I'm saying?
I lose it, man. I challenge you.
When we first started, Fee was, I don't want to say fat, but he had a belly. He's lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, I lost. I was like 178, but I'm down in like 165. I'm brolic.
Nah, so I got to lose weight, though, because the doctor told me I'm going to keep having them back problems because my body not used to supporting this weight.
Yeah, that's how I feel.
Those big titties?
Nah, I ain't got no titties. You feel me? All
right, I got to look up. Brolic only came up in Urban Dictionary, by the way.
Yeah, brolic means swole, big.
I can't read even what it says because it says words that I can't say.
In the urban, did you look it up on Google?
I Googled it. The first
how
thing
you spell it,
brolic.
H.
What do you mean H? Where does that H come from?
The H instead of the K. Real shit.
Let's see.
Da 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 da.
Da 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 da. Brawling. Da, 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 da. Let's see. Oh.
Yeah.
Wait, wait. Let's see what brawling means. Doop, 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 doop. That was, it's a boat. Brolic.
Oh, how big is a boat?
I don't think brolic's a real, no, I'm telling, man, you, it's not a real word.
Hey, Siri.
I don't think it's a real word, but it's a look word that's made up.
I've never heard it before, too.
Nah, it's not a real word, but you know, just like when you go to neighborhoods, people make up words and it happens.
We've talked about this before. When brolic. Somebody says a new word around you, do you like look it up? Or do you just automatically accept whatever they say? Nah, and go, oh, I understand it.
Nah, I if just I tell you to say down. Less, what am I saying to you?
What, say less?
If I say less.
I mean, say no, chill out. Say no more. I get it. I understand. I dig it. You feel me? When I be like, all right, you got it, say less. You feel me? I don't want to hear that shit no more. Just leave it alone.
See, he understands almost as I do.
No, he don't.
Yes, he
does. Yeah, maybe he does. With you, Kabi. When I say less, what I'm saying?
Yeah, that, yeah. Like, but the like, way he talk, just, it depends on because sometimes
if, I, if know, I'm saying if I'm saying yo, if you saying yo, bro, I got a studio session this and the third, yada yada yada, and you telling me I need you to pull up, say less.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I mean, you coming. Yeah, you feel me?
But the way you just described it was the way I think of it.
Nah, because it's on how you use it too, or depend on like, say if me and you arguing, I'm like, I'm gonna fuck you up. Or you be like, or some shit, you be like, all right, say less. And you talking shit to somebody, all right, say less. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I want to hear that shit. You feel me? It depends on how you're using it and where you and how you're using it.
See, whenever I hear a word I've never heard, I always look it up.
Right,
and doing this podcast, up, I've been all like, right. I have not understood almost zero things what you said. I'll sit here and go, what the fuck was that word? or I might just say, Theo, what the hell is that? Like, yeah. Theo loves say less. That's his favorite word. No, or favorite
say
saying.
Say less. Say that.
So speaking of saying things. Say you guys were to die. You guys are going to die, right?
Yeah, we all going to die.
You guys are both musicians.
You live to die.
Theo, we've talked about this before. You've had almost a year to come up with this. What's the bar or lyric you want on your tombstone that you've performed before? In one of your songs, whatever it is.
Damn.
What do you want your tombstone to read? Theo, you've had so long. I haven't asked you this question forever.
Go ahead, you first.
Because I'm thinking shit. I mean, that's a good question.
What are people going to remember you by? What expression or saying or bar or lyric do you want people to go? That sums up who K Dusse or Theo Dolce as a person.
I know exactly what it is. I know exactly what it is. Now, I don't write my lyrics, so I got to like hear the end of it. But I know exactly what it is.
Damn, that's a good question. I'm still thinking over here.
I got you, bro. I mean, once you hear this one, you're going to be like, yup,
that's it right there, bro.
This is the thinking music around here.
Din, din, din. Yo, welcome to the Love and Demo podcast. I'm your gracious host, Theo Dolce, and you're here after hours with us. You could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with us. And we want to thank you for showing up today.
I wish I had a burp right now.
As we have some more good topics and good beer for you to enjoy. Ooh, yeah. The sweet sounds of K Dusse on the track. Ooh, yeah. With Justin Judge.
Hey.
At the helm. We want to thank you for showing up and giving us your time.
Pick that gavel up, B.
At the end of this, at the end of my voice, we will send you a link for $9.99 to hear more of my fine ass.
All right, what's your lyric, Theo?
It's saying, if I'm not on top of the world, if I'm not on top by the time I can't think of it at the moment. If I'm not on top by the time I pass, I mean I failed at life. If I'm not on top, especially in this game we in, if I'm not on top by the time it's over, I failed at life.
What song is this in?
It's called Halo.
Halo?
It's a song called Halo.
Hey, Dusse, what you got?
I'm still thinking shit. That's a good question.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom because I always have to pay. I got that chrome with me. I got some niggas
that's gonna send niggas home for me. I got that guy. Yeah, man, we in here. Ain't no one owning this because can't no one clone this shit. All on my phone and shit. Since I was 23, nigga, been in my zone and shit. Giving them substance style. A small bot when I flow. I feel like I felt life if I ain't on top when I go. Well,
yeah. I get up there.
I don't even, I'm trying to think.
Yo, it's hard though, cause that's like on the spot, like a motherfucker. How I'm supposed to?
Shit, I man.
Come on, man. You got to put it on your tombstone. People got to remember you. You got four kids.
Yeah.
You got the fans. You got everyone listening.
Yeah, but it's probably it won't be.
Hope don't cry when I know. Have you heard? I love 36 Mafia, by the way. You guys listen to 36 Mafia?
Yeah.
Fuck no.
Hope don't cry when I nut in your
Project
eye.
Project Pat, all of them. Yeah,
that's so fucking cool. Funny. Oh, sorry, go ahead. K Dusse.
Oh, well, hold on.
Ass and titties. Ass and titties. ass. Kill them. 36 Mafia.
I don't like 36 Mafia.
Oh my God, they're so funny.
Like, cause I wrote a song, I guess I'm gonna call it the Real Prosper.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
The Real Prosper. That's what I wanted to say. Cause you know, all real niggas, all real people.
Sounds
prosper.
Like a DMX song almost.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that is.
Like,
I love DMX.
I feel you. I love Jay Z.
Yeah, he trash, but go on.
Just like Eminem.
Oh, man, I like them both, man.
Who better, Eminem or Jay Z?
Hold on. Let's get his lyric out, and then we're going to talk. I don't want... Eminem's obviously better. It's not even a competition. We're going, sir.
That's a good question. Because, you know what I mean? To say it, because their lyrics is different.
But like, no, we're going into your... We want to hear your tune, sir.
We're not going to get into it, because he doesn't want to be disappointed, so
I'm never disappointed.
Let's go. Let's
go
into your
tombstone. Here lies K Dusse. What does he say? Born in 1974.
Fucking right, yeah, you pussy.
I just guessed the year. I just said a year.
Nah, yeah, 83.
That's pretty close.
That's when you was born, 83.
Yeah.
Shit, I was born in 82.
Yeah, my birthday was on the 18th.
My birthday next week.
Yeah, I just turned 39.
I ain't even gonna lie to you. I don't even know how old I was gonna be turning next week if I was born in 82, but sound good.
Mm-hmm. Nah, I was about to say, you're gonna be down there, you're gonna be 40.
40. Oh, yeah, because 82, 22, yeah.
Nah, because I'm 39, so yeah.
40.
Come on, we gotta hear your tombstone,
I don't
bro.
Know, man. I don't know.
How about this? We get into what is your. I wanna get past this, but I also wanna circle back to it. So let's go into. What is your aspiration for your music? What do you want out of being a hip-hop artist?
Man, shit, you know, besides being my own boss and getting rich, man, like, I love doing it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? If I got to make some music, and I can make some music that motivate people, that get people through their day, to get people through their struggle, you know what I'm saying, then I felt like I achieved something.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because, you know, music always, like, every time, like, music is life.
Yeah.
Because no matter how you look at it, from the old times to now, every time somebody got mad, mm-hmm. every time somebody went through something, what did they do? Even if they were stressing, they sitting in the car listening to their favorite song, probably drinking themselves crazy, everything.
See, the reason for this podcast is I went through a bad divorce, and the only thing I can find, like, music was a big outlet for me, but also podcasts, because music was like something I almost like. I was self-harming myself almost. I wanted to listen to, like, sad songs. I was like, I want to just cry. But I also wanted to hear people talk about some shit that was funny.
Yeah.
So I was like, I went to listen to podcasts where it was, like, just people in a room talking, where I was like, I can think about something besides my divorce and, you know, my bullshit, all my sad bullshit.
Yeah.
At and the same
got
time,
you through, right?
It got me through. At the same time, calling that whore a whore. You're a whore. I mean.
Yeah. It felt good, right?
Yeah. It's fucking amazing.
Fucking hoe.
She's like a hoe.
$2.
Oh, show.
Bitch. $2. Bitch.
So, I mean, podcasts helped me get through something. Theo, what about you? What's your aspiration? I mean, so I want my aspiration for this podcast. So, going back to you, just Dang. Aspiration. My aspiration was like just helping one person because I was suicidal when I was going through my podcast or going through my divorce.
See,
so, I was like, I just want to help somebody think about something else besides their divorce at the time.
And if I could have music that could help you not do that, then you feel me? That I feel like I've done something right.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like, you know what I mean? I'm giving the world a part of me. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. What about you, Theo?
Biggest aspirations to make me want to do music?
No, for your music.
Biggest.
Let's say for mine and my own, because you got a big team.
Oh, biggest aspiration for mine and my own is for everybody to succeed. If I can make sure, if I can put everybody in a position, when I win, we win as a unit, then I'm great. I'm happy.
Would you rather be known as the greatest producer? Like, so let's say everyone else in your camp can succeed and they're all super famous and everything. Would you rather that and nobody knows your name, or you are super famous and nobody knows their name?
I'd rather be behind the scenes where if they all pop and nobody knows my name, on the reason that they popped, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like on the production end. But as far as that, I don't ever think, like, I can't think like that because I don't ever think it would be like that, because other than just me producing everything, I'm on top of it. Like, I'm in the camp with them. So they're going to see me, you know what I'm saying, but not know that I'm, like, behind it. Yeah, I'm just a part of the team. Like, you know, I always look at, I seen something that says a strong team, you can see a strong team. A strong team is only, how can I put it? How you could tell a strong team is when you could look at a team and not know who the leader is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's a strong team because everybody can kind of be in their dreams. But for that, I would love to see everybody get on. My biggest aspirations for me is just to change my life through music. Like, if you told me I could get paid $15 an hour to do music all day, I'm with it. I ain't tripping about it. No raises or nothing. Yeah. I don't give a fuck.
I do overtime because it's something I love to do.
Exactly. So, yeah, I mean, my biggest aspiration is just to change my life, or not even change my life, change my family life, and just stay afloat. You know what I'm saying? The shit that my parents are getting older and breaking down, I want to change their life, even if it's for 2 days.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Let's take this ride out. Go stay in this big whole, this mansion. I only got enough for these 2 days. But live like that for me. I just want y'all to feel those. I mean, we struggled all our lives. So that's my biggest aspiration, just the people around me to just see that it's something bigger in life and that their life has value. Mm-hmm. Before they go, like, you mean, I did this before I passed. I was able to do this. I want to be able to do that for them.
So going off of that, let's get into our Theo thought of the day.
Theo motherfucking thought, and I ain't even gonna lie to you. Back to these Theo thoughts in my soft voice. They call me Theo Dolce. Call me Dolce if you're nasty, mama.
Yo,
I love the little.
the little. What do you have that's little?
This boy is a fucking nut, man.
He
fucked it up. Turn that shit off. hold on, let me get
to your Theo thought.
Theo thoughts. If a woman was born, say, y'all about to be like, wait, hold up. Turn that shit. Fuck Theo thought. Damn, man, I ain't even gonna lie. I got so many notes in here. I lost the thoughts real quick. Hold on. Turn the music back on, bro. Hold on.
Here we go. Back into Theo thoughts.
Back into Theo thoughts.
we try to give Theo a thought every
Yo, day. Every time this shit come out, I always got to do that. Like,
one day you gonna cover him. My boy gonna be here doing a podcast. No clothes on. With the music playing.
With a red light on. Did you know that I was here?
You ever heard
with a silk t-shirt on.
You ever heard of OnlyFans?
Have you ever had silk underwear, bro? I fart the hole right out of the bottom.
Bro, you gonna put a
I
hole
fart
in
the
that.
Holes right through them. Like, there's nothing left. When I was a kid in high school, I had silk underwear because I thought it was a good idea. Every time. Lasts about a week with my farts.
So, yeah, man, I think I might have brought this up, but it since you're here, I could, like, bring these thoughts back. So
bring it back.
One of the questions was, is there a difference? Do you believe there's a difference between being talented and gifted?
Yeah.
So what's the difference?
Because when you're gifted, it's like you was born with it. It's like it's a natural thing. But when you talented, You feel me? It's like the same thing.
Basically,
it's like the same thing. You feel me? You got it.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? Because you can have all the talent, but you know what I mean? If you don't have no work ethic, then that shit is just a waste. Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean? That being blessed with it, and that it's like the same thing to me. You know what I'm saying? Because you got it. You don't.
Right. Okay. What you think?
We've discussed this before, but let me get back into it. So, Michael Phelps is one of those people in my mind who is gifted. I say this because other swimmers who have swam with him, and I'm not a swimming fan, this is just an example I know, that they said he never practiced, he never had to do anything. He was just who he was innately. Like his body type, everything about him, he was just a perfect swimmer. He didn't have to practice for it.
And he smoked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He did whatever the fuck he felt like because, I mean, but they always said, imagine if he practiced.
Yeah, that's like Allen Iverson.
I was just about to say that. So
imagine if he practiced, how good he could have been. He's the best of all time. He's the best swimmer that was ever recorded.
Yeah, here, hear me out with the gifted and talented thing. Allen Iverson is gifted.
Talented too.
But Allen Iverson was given his gift to just be good. Kobe Bryant is talented. What I'm saying that is, you have the talent to be great, right? You got to work at it.
Yeah,
see how Kobe mimicked his game after
MJ.
MJ, because he could do that. You know what I'm saying? Some people can't mimic their game to be like that. It takes the talent. And I'm not saying that Kobe isn't gifted, but when you look at gifts, you look at people like Allen Iverson. You look at people like LeBron James, who are just given these gifts to be great. Where it's other people that come in the league and have to work at being, trying to sustain that. Like for example, like DeMar DeRozan. How talented he is, how good he is. He's not like gifted. He's not. Ja Morant is a gifted athlete.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? Russell Westbrook is talent. Don't ever disrespect my man like that. See, now I gotta get brolic with you, bro. That's my man.
And how many bricks that
That's my
shoot?
Man. I don't care.
We all agree Dak Prescott is garbage. So that was a decision made by the judge. I can't help what happened. It was already declared. It's a point of law. I mean.
But basically what I'm saying is just that like Russell Westbrook is very talented. Yeah, that's my favorite player. He's very talented. But as far as like gifted, it took him a while to get to where he is. Whereas people that come in that's just naturally
he naturally had it even in college at UCLA. That motherfucker fast, man.
He's fast. So look, what I'm saying is
and he could jump.
It's a difference between being I look at it like it's a difference between being talented and gifted. A talent is something that you could do. Everybody kind of have hidden talents that they can do. When you have a gift to just be, it's like when you got a gift, it's like that's your purpose to be. People that's talented don't they talented. They don't have the purpose. Like I could play basketball and football. That's not saying that they're my gifts to be. Like music is my gift, but I can bust your ass in ball at any point in time. It's just a talent that I have. That it's a part of me.
Just where you like Westbrook.
You know what I'm saying? Stop disrespecting my man.
Man, that nigga
I wouldn't want him to come to the Sixers, though. I wouldn't want him to.
See, look at that. But that's your man, though. Why you don't want your man to come to the Sixers?
I don't want him to. It's not. But that's just my thing. Like, looking at people like LeBron James, that's a fucking gift.
Yeah.
Joel Embiid, that's a fucking gift.
But their body's made for it, too.
But you know what I'm saying? That they were born with this actual. Where, for example, let's just, he could play. LeBron played other sports. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, he played football. Now, AI is a gifted person because he was elite at basketball and football. Yeah. Where
a quarterback, too.
Yeah, where people go play another sport because they're talented. They could do it. I'm athletic. I could do this, man. It's when you're gifted. Deion Sanders is gifted. Like, when you think about it, that's a gift that you're given.
What's O.J. Simpson?
Gifted. Killer.
Gifted. He was so good at murder. He was so good at best murder of all time.
Hey, yo, my dog OJ.
He didn't do it.
Get off
OJ didn't do it.
Yo, leave Orinthius James alone.
No, he did so good at murder. He was so good at murder that they had to stop making a truck. They literally stopped making a truck. They're like, we can't make the Bronco anymore. He was so good at murder and got away with it. They're like, you know what? Let's take 20 years off of this truck because we just have to stop.
They stopped making isotoners too.
Did y'all watch Dave Chappelle?
Yeah.
Yo, so did y'all see the episode when he first started, when he was he had the white girl singing?
Yeah.
And he was like, everything he said, he would write it down and give it to her. He was like, OJ didn't do it. And he gave it to her. She's like, OJ didn't do it. And then he was like, never mind. Yes, he did. I was like, yo, this bull crazy, man.
Man, OJ ain't do it, man.
Come on now.
Ooh, speaking of that then, right. Is what's his name I was just talking about? Dave Chappelle.
Yeah.
Is Dave Chappelle gifted?
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, guaranteed.
Boom.
Yeah, he's
Kevin Hart gifted?
I think he's more talented. I think he works harder than
you. You get what I'm saying?
That's I think he works hard. Chappelle doesn't have to work.
He does. Exactly. Like
he just walks in a room and he's...
Kevin Hart is funny, but it goes above beyond to be funny.
He Kevin got the Hart talent. Very funny, but I think Cat Williams is gifted too.
Did Cat Williams go crazy? I haven't seen him in 20 years.
Most people that's like... That are like...
My boy had it all, man. My boy was thugging.
Ooh, I got something for y'all.
The thuggest, ruggest, right.
I got something for you. What? It's Kendrick Lamar, gifted or talented?
Both.
Is J. Cole gifted or talented?
I got to go with both, too.
All right, so Cole, one of my favorite rappers, but he's talented.
He's gifted, too.
Kendrick Lamar is gifted.
Man, you got
well, no. You know what? Cause J. Cole produces bro, and all that shit.
Think about it. What he produces. Not only do he produces, but you got to listen to the shit they say too.
No, I'm great
because
with lyrics
because he's painting. They paint pictures.
Kendrick Lamar is next world out of gifted to the T. Like out of the them three, them four. Kendrick is over Drake, Cole, all of them to me.
See, like 42 Doug, he's talented.
Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. Lil Baby is gifted. The Baby is talented.
Lil Baby is like
too many babies out there. Everything. There's too many babies.
Just like Lil Durk is talented. He's not gifted at all. Like, you know what I mean, it's Durk. Come on, bro. He's not. Talented. He's very not talented. He's very talented, but he's not gifted. Like, you mean, gifted is like Mac Miller. That's a gifted dude.
He was so good. He was gifted death. K Dusse.
K Dusse. That's some.
Speaking of death, K Dusse. Yeah, you're gifted death today. What's the lyric that we had last chance before we get into promotions?
I ain't never heard no shit like that before in my life.
He died. I mean, that's what happened.
He was gifted death.
Congratulations.
Wow.
Cancel me.
Yo, he different.
Before you cancel me, subscribe. Go on, sir.
Shit, I ain't gonna be here no more. It was real.
My boy say back.
He was gifted death. Congratulations.
He did it to himself too, though.
So did Juice WRLD, yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta understand when enough is enough. Shit.
When is enough enough?
God damn.
When is enough enough?
God damn.
All right. Do you have something winning your tombstone, or you just want nothing there? Nobody should say anything about you.
Nah, just play my shit.
But what are they playing? What's the song then? Let's give us.
I don't know, man. Cause you know what I'm saying. I don't know. Cause I haven't.
Mama. Ooh. Let's get into promotions. K Dusse, you have a camera sitting right in front of you, up over there. Sorry, to your right shoulder. Please promote what you like to promote, sir. Anything you want to promote?
Go ahead. All right, man. Yeah, man. I got an album coming out in a week and a half. K Dusse, the beginning. 8 songs on it. I'm going to have 2 singles I'm going to do off of it, bring it back, and start it off with nothing. It's going to be my 2 singles that I do.
Okay, Theo, sir. You know where the camera is. I don't have to tell you where it is. You've been here for a while. Tell the world about you.
I'm K Dusse Instagram.
Oh, my bad.
K_Dusse_103. K_Dusse Facebook, you know, TikTok, all that. You can find me.
He be dancing on TikTok.
I might.
I don't get this. Hold on, before I promote this, how the hell is you drinking Henny if your name Dusse? But
because,
hey.
Because a lot of the stores don't have Dusse.
I mean, I'm telling Jay, you cheating
gotta understand,
on me with that bullshit.
You got to understand the area
Jay-Z,
I live in,
Jay-Z, he's
okay?
Cheating on you with bullshit.
You got to understand the area I live in, all right?
All right, so one more question before I get into my joint. Jay-Z or Eminem? And don't give me no long-ass answer. Just give me who's better.
That's a tough question for me, man.
Jay or Jay? Who you when you leave here? Who you put on first?
No, I will bump Jay first, of
my
course.
Man. That's all
but,
I needed. I'm
but
sorry.
But M is very lyrical.
That's cool
because right. You know what I mean. They both from different eras. Like
Jay-Z, no, they not
on the street. No, I'm talking about like Jay-Z street nigga. Think about it.
Yeah, no, I know that. I know that.
Eminem, he's not. You feel me? He grew up in a trailer park. You feel me? He had a rough as shit too, but he's not a street dude.
Deuce, can I call you Deuce? Yeah, Deuce, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. For sure, Deuce. Yeah, it's all good. Deuce, you already gave the answer.
No, Theo's trying to. Theo's walking the dog right
Big
now.
Big Deuce.
He's trying to dog walk you right now.
K Deuce.
Because K Deuce was about to give the answer.
But,
I'm not.
Because like you know what I mean, I listen to Slim
Shady. Did you listen
Shady
to J. Cole or Lil Dicky?
J. Cole.
Fuck out of here. I'm with you. I'm just, that was.
Oh, Lil Dicky, by the way.
Lil Dicky, nice.
My dream guest.
He all right, you feel me? But.
He would love to have Lil Dicky on here.
That's my top guest.
But you know, everybody got their twist, man.
Yeah. Mine's is a soda can. You're still Dolce, you know. Mine of my own. You can't see it. It's all white today. You know what I mean? It's some exclusive shit. But, you mean, be on the lookout for Mind of My Own, the whole camp, Theo Dolce. Also be looking out for Premium. That's all I'm going to say is Premium, man. All gas. All gas. You know what I'm saying? No brakes, you know what I mean? I ain't got brakes on my bike. That was nasty,
I was trying to give you some gas. I worked hard for that, bro. I worked so hard to get that burn.
I don't want that gas, man. That gas don't get me fried.
That's not premium gas?
Fuck no, that's
I tried my best. I did my best.
He gave me some regular. He gave me propane. that going a little lighter.
Gave motherfucker some Reggie.
I did my best.
But yeah, Mind of My Own, you know what I'm saying? Be on the lookout for Mind of My Own. Be on the lookout for We Over Me, the camp. Yeah, that's all I got. You mean Theo Dolce, Mind of My Own. Loving Then What, K Dusse.
Yes.
Mr. Everybody. You know how we rocking.
Hey, you call me by the right nickname, by the way.
Mr. Everybody.
He called me Mr.
Hot Chip.
Mr. Hot Shit, I wouldn't say, because that shit, after know, that your, chip
your
was
ass
the shit.
Is on fire. That chip
it was not, like, that I shit just,
is, like, I told my son,
what up, gangsta?
I told my son, I'm going to give him one, he eat it, I'm going to buy him a $200 Robux gift card.
It fucks you up.
Man, you going to have that little nigga in the hospital.
I'm trying
to. Hot daddy.
I got to teach him a lesson.
He's a hot boy. So, by the way, I want to thank K Dusse for coming on, of course. Check out his new album. Theo Dolce, Mind of My Own. I'm not going to promote you, Afro Man, because you have yet to perform and yet to experience what Love and Then One has to offer. So nothing to you, sir. Nay, sir, nay. I just want to thank you guys again both for coming on. I had a great time. Great episode.
Yeah.
Hey, that was a good show.
Yeah. I can't look forward to it. I just started working out again. First time in 10 years.
Being your dick is not working out, bro.
Yeah. What?
It's working on the body. It's working on this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Thank you for watching that video on YouTube. Remember to like and subscribe this video, share it with your friends, follow us at Love and Them One on Instagram, and go to theloveandthemone.com. New full episodes every Tuesday, highlights throughout the week, and previews on Sundays, full audio every Monday.
What he said.